right, Wolverine Nations, welcome to the den here, Wolverine Den, as we get ready for tonight's big matchup with the Athens Wildcats. We've got the first Section 4 girls dual meet in the history of New York State Wrestling here tonight. So with the Wildcats, an established team coming from across the border, and they're going to face off against our first-year Wolverines as they come out and have that first dual meet. I'm joined here by Dr. Pat Owen, former college wrestler, college coach, local. He was a Wildcat as well, so we'd bring him in to hang out, give a little Wildcat side of the conversation here. So
this is very exciting. I was a little late as usual, and I had trouble finding parking because there are so many people here. It's exciting to see a match bringing that many people in. So, and it's been the talk. I mean, especially having like a girls' dual meet. I'm very excited about this.
Yeah, I'm sure Jimmy McClough was standing there setting up there somewhere watching down on this and remembering the big matches that he had with Johnson City, Athens, Sarah, Tawanda. I mean, just Unionicott, great matches where they'd have to watch it on closed circuit television. And it's starting to get that juice again. I mean, when I came in today, they were doing peewee matches, and it was packed and full, and great numbers for both those rec programs. So
that's
awesome.
Wonderful. Yeah.
Awesome. So we're pretty excited. I mean, we got some big matches today. We do have, even though there was no certified girls wrestling last year, there was a girls state championship where they had girls from all over the state come in. And we do have one of the representatives, a state champion from the Waverly Wolverines, who will be in the lineup tonight. And that is, she will be Mackenzie LaForest. She'll be one of the upper weights today. So we will get a chance to see that state champion, some other kids to highlight through there. The Waverly heavyweight is a Section 4, returning Section 4 champion. He's going to face off, my thought, the match of the night with Josh Nittinger, who was, I believe, went to regionals last year.
Yeah, I'm excited about seeing that. That and also Ty Beeman's match against Caleb.
Right? Yeah.
Nason.
Yeah, that was a big match last year, a match that Athens won 51-10 or 51-18, I think, last year. So Nason was down about 10-0 in that match, and he headlocked Beeman and pinned him. So
Little surprise. Yeah.
I'm sure they're pretty excited to see each other again. A couple other kids, Keegan Congan kid, 172-pound sophomore from Athens, pretty solid. And then you also have one of the captains of the Waverly team, Josh Courtney. Josh is going to be wrestling for Waverly. His brother Jake will be wrestling for Athens. So that's interesting. They're not in the same weight class. Luckily, that would be kind of a tough thing at the house tonight. But there's a lot of crossovers in this. I mean, the Wells boy Matthias is in the Waverly lineup as an eighth grader this year. He attended Athens up till this year, so he came in here.
Cooper with his family between back and forth. It's like with AJ.
Yeah, like, Cooper. Cooper is another kid that, you know what I mean, that was in the Waverly school system for a while and went to the Athens school system. So these kids know each other. I mean, this is gonna be a pretty good matchup. So we're pretty excited. Don't want to forget though. We also got Connor Stotler in the lineup. Connor 7-0, coming off a huge weekend up to Horseheads.
He looked good.
He looked real tough. So we're pretty excited. All right, so we're gonna go back down to the mat right now as we get ready to start our first girls wrestling match here. All right, we're out here on the mat. So in our first matchup, we got Lillian Wright. Actually, we don't. This looks like an exhibition match here. I believe this is an exhibition match we got right off the bat. Looks like I've got Paul versus Holmes on this one here. So you're going to see your homestanding Waverly is going to be in the white with gray with the red Waverly across the front.
They really worked hard on getting the singlets for the Athens girls. I know they picked those out last year.
Yeah, they're pretty sharp, right? Like, I mean, it's good double leg. Yeah. Reaching in on a good double leg. Good sprawl there. She's working short offense as she brings her to the mat. We're looking for a spin. Got some head pressure there. Looks like that's going to be a good 2 points. 2 points to court. Secured by the Wolverine. This is Alana Holmes, all right? So Alana's a first-year wrestler. She's a ninth grader as she steps out against a Paul girl from Athens. I don't have her first name. I don't have her on their roster. You're going to see her a couple of times. They've got a couple matches in there for her tonight. All right, so she's got a one-on-one on the far side there, Coach Owen. She's looking
just
for a half.
To get base. Look away.
She's going for a half Nelson here. Waverly girl working hard for a half. She's got a one-on-one on the other side. She's got her feet underneath her. Start driving that.
Keeping the pressure right on top of her, not letting her get up to her base.
Looks like Donnie Bauer's out there calling the match. Donnie from wrestled for Watkins Glen back in the day. His dad was a coach and official, so good to see that next generation there. Got 20 seconds left in the period. Waverly in pretty good shape on top. 2-0.
2-0.
You think Coach Owen working those one-on-ones?
Working the one-on-ones. Yeah.
She's keeping her pressure up front.
And she's actually getting off the side as well, so she's not riding parallel. She's off the side working something. So.
A good first period. That short offense takedown for two. That's going to put Holmes up 2-0 over Paul. Looks like it's going to be Athens' choice in the second period. Athens is going to defer. Holmes says, I want to go down.
All right, see this ride.
Holmes gets set. 2-0 lead here. Paul on top. Holmes looks
to stand
break
up. Down. Ooh. Suck her back. Suck her back.
All right. She works.
Like, get up to her base. Get up to her base.
Ooh. All right, we're in this neutral position here. There we go. There's one for the Waverly girl.
Listen Holmes. To that crowd.
Yeah, it's a nice crowd. Oh. You see across the way, you can see there isn't hardly a place to set over there. Both the girls in a head and arm tie.
Seems like Paul's getting a little tired out there.
I think both of them are a little tired right now. So you see she wants to go back to the first period there, Doc Owen, where she wants to pull down that, get that short offense.
Get that short offense going, a little takedown.
I watched her. Oh, look at that arm drag. She did an arm drag to a short double. I like it. I like the thought process there.
Still 1:10 left in the second period. 3-0.
There you go. We got a pass by go. Waverly with a takedown. There's a good two. She's going right. She's still driving. She's going right for the fall. She wants to get. She's looking for back points. Ah, you can tell it's early in the season, Doc Owen. They're breathing heavy like you and me on a deer hunt.
Oh, let her up.
Oh, she cut her. All right. So all right. What she did is with the rule change a couple years ago, you can just tell the official, you put your hands up, and they'll start in the neutral position and give your opponent 1 point. So Holmes just chose to give her opponent 1 point. She worked her short offense. Now she gives up the single leg.
Ooh. Is that giving her up going to pay off for her or not?
I don't know. Paul's in good position.
She's in a position. She can get up. Nope. Oh, let go of it. Let go.
All she's got to do is spin around to get two. She spins around. She's got two. There she goes. She goes under the arm. That's a good solid 2 points there for Holmes. She's up 7-1 now. 22 seconds left in the second period. Been watching too much football. I almost said second half.
Second half.
No, I've been watching those Wolverines. A lot of those Wolverines will be out on the mat tonight. Got played in those big football games. We got a. All right, this is going to be a penalty call. Interlocking. Against Waverly. She was hustling side to side with that one-on-one. Got her hands touched there. They give you a second of reaction time. They're trying to call it pretty slow with the girls this year because they do have so many first and second year wrestlers. But it's a varsity sport. Rules are the rules. So on they go.
And that's
3 seconds.
But that's what's amazing, how new these girls are to the sport and how quickly they're picking it up.
Yeah, I mean, this is wrestling, right? Yeah. Like, I mean, we're watching wrestling. I mean, these girls have figured out how to wrestle. They've had good coaches. I know you got the father-son tandem of
the Whites.
The Whites over on the Athens side.
Dave and Jay, they've been working very hard with the girls all year, or last couple years.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely, it shows, you know what I mean, if they put that work in. So we've got Justin Wilkett coaching the girls on the other side. And, you know, he was a section champ for the Wolverines. I'm going to date myself. I'm trying to think of when that was there. It must have been probably 2007. Man, these guys are young. I was coaching for years by then. Oh, Athens with a big move on top. She's got the Aptos and she's driving. Oh. She's right behind. Oh. She's looking for points. She's got points. This could be a big turnaround.
She keeps that pitch.
I mean, Holmes was up 7-2. She just got flopped over on her back. She's going to have to fight off her back here. She's a lot of time.
A lot of time. Minute and a half left.
I tell you what, there's no quit. The Holmes girl's not quitting on it, but she's close. We just lost the feet. Huh? You just stop and start it? Okay.
Well, we wish we could explain to you what's happening right now.
I mean, the guys are working on the feed right now. Somehow, YouTube just booted us out of their system. So, the camera booted us out of the system. So, they're working right now feverishly to try to get that back up. And you know, that was before we start our first regular match of that dual meet. This first match is an exhibition between Miss Paul and Miss Holmes. And we left you hanging on the edge of their seat.
We want to see. Kind of want to get up and go over and look in the window, see what happened.
Yeah, why don't you do that?
Yeah,
we're gonna go get an update from the window. Dr. Owen gonna make the trip over. So, this is the beauty of running your own live stream TV center. So I got my freshmen over here and sophomores looking at me, going, "We're figuring it out." All right, we're back on with something here. Okay, so we bring you back to action. There's 30 seconds left in the third period. Obviously, she didn't get pinned because Miss Holmes is up 9-7. She's up 9-7. So we've got 30 seconds left in the match. Looks like we've got a little blood time here. Both girls seem severely winded. So we're going to see who can finish this match out. So what a way to start. Barn burner, first match.
Very exciting, very exciting. 9-7.
All right, they come back to the center here. It looks like it's going to be Waverly down. Athens on top.
Oh. Looking for a turn.
Oh, she gave it to her. She turned right into it again. Same thing she did in the beginning of the third period. Now she stands. There you go. This is magic right there. Now.
Ooh, there we go.
20 seconds. She got one. That should make it 10-7. These guys are going.
The pass by.
She takes her to the mat. She's going to pretty much ice this right here. She's up 11-7. Oh, big lift. Big lift.
Wow. Oh,
Miss Holmes will not be denied.
Great match. Great match.
Ilana. She says, "Welcome to my house." Here we go. So what a great match. Both girls. Miss Paul, the same thing. What a competitor. Come back in that third period.
Back,
down pat. She's down 7-2. Brings it all the way back 9-7.
9-7.
What a competitive match for these guys. Great job. I guess this is what makes me proud of seeing these guys step out there, get out of their comfort zone, and just get after it. So, and be good sports, you know? Okay, so I've got on mine here, I've got Lillian Wright coming in from Waverly, and I have a Kolsar from Athens. That's what I have on my sheet. So I think we're like...
Coaches and captains, please report to the table.
I have a feeling if they have the same paperwork I have in front of me that nobody can read the handwriting. So that's what I think the issue probably is.
It must be an Athens thing. My handwriting. This looks like my handwriting, and it must be from Athens. But if it's Coach White from senior, it's Troy.
Well, when I
Troy
asked
Coach, right?
When I
Troy
asked Coach Whitman,
graduate.
I said, "Coach Whitman, I said, did you seriously write this?" He did. He did, but blame it on Jay White. So,
okay. All right.
He threw the heat over there.
Jay, I will never pick on anybody about their handwriting. So mine is horrible as well.
Yeah, Jay, longtime teacher, longtime coach at Athens. I was Troy grad back in Russell Mansfield University. So I was a science teacher for many years. Coached by his son, David, state champion for Athens, and also a
national qualifier.
National qualifier for Binghamton University. Started for West Point for a couple of years before transferring into Binghamton. I was at an international tournament up in Canada a few years ago, and I was up there coaching a couple of guys from Cornell, and who comes walking across the mat wrestling freestyle up there with David White.
David was there.
It's like, David, man. We were up at the Canadian National Open, and he's like, hey, how are you, Mr. Knowles? I'm like, how are you doing, man? So he still puts him on and goes a little bit. I know he's helping out with the Elmira boys team, Elmira College team. So.
Oh, David is?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
All right, so this looks like Ms. Colesar here. Oh, no, this is Wheeler.
Oh,
this is
Wheeler.
A forfeit at 107. So Waverly okay. does not have a competitor at 107. That's going to put Athens up front, or Athens up front 6-0. Wheeler takes a forfeit and gets us to 114, where we'll have Colesar facing Lillian Wright. Lillian in the traditional red and white of the Wolverines. Nice walk-up song there. These guys are doing it right.
I like it.
I like it, yeah. So, listen, I saw Lillian wrestle last weekend. She's pretty solid. Good in top position and neutral position. So the Colesar name is a name. I grew up with some Colesars up in Shishiquin, Pennsylvania, outside of Athens there. So it's a tough farming family up there. So I think that's probably got some roots there.
Little head and arm tie. Ooh, look at
Colesar,
that.
Nice shot.
Oh,
she's going to get to two.
That was close.
The ref had good position there. I'll tell you, Donnie's a good ref. Does a nice job. We had him last weekend at Horseheads. He was really solid in that, especially for being as early as it is. He's going to earn his salary tonight doing all three matches, the junior high and that.
Well, just like the wrestlers, the officials also have time to get used to the season.
Colesar super aggressive.
Ooh,
look at how
look
she's
at that.
Up towards
that's
the head.
That's deep, deep.
Yeah, she's got her in trouble. Wright's in
minute
trouble
and a
here.
Half.
Colesar looks like she's tough.
She's got the pressure right on there.
She lifts the head beautifully.
Keeps her hip. Chest
position.
To chest.
Yeah. Wright's gonna be, yeah, I was going to say, there's no way she's making it out of this period. So Colesar starts us off with a pin in the actual dual meet. Going to put the Wildcats up 12-0 over the Wolverines. So we've got Chloe Bennett at 120 pounds. She's going to face off against Emma Vanderhoof. Emma, obviously, superintendent of schools here at Waverly, so I know the Waverly kids a little bit better. But Emma is a – well, and it's our broadcast, so there you go. Emma's a swimmer for us.
I was going to say, I thought she swam.
Yeah, she did. Yeah. She was a good swimmer.
I forget New York is swimming in the fall.
Swim is in the fall. So. Yeah. This will be Emma's probably third or fourth career match. So she's facing off against Chloe Bennett here.
But she's Stotler's cousin, right?
She's Ethan Stotler. Many people remember from being a section champ, third in the state a few years ago. And now Connor's there. And after Connor, there's one more. We got Riley. Riley will probably be in the lineup tonight, too. Emma comes out aggressive. Swung down there by Bennett. Bennett picks up a quick two. Bennett on top, looking for a bar. She gets a far bar. Athens girl's very aggressive there, Pat.
Very aggressive.
She's got to.
I really like how they're getting off to the side, not hanging out parallel.
Very coachable. They don't have bad habits, right?
They don't have bad habits, right.
So she's got
look
a double
at,
bar
set. Tight. That is tight. Look at that positioning.
Emma, you are finding out one of the more interesting places in wrestling right now. This is a double arm bar situation.
Double arm bar. My shoulders hurt thinking about it.
Yeah. This is tough. I'll tell you what, great technique by the Bennett girl.
Oh, she looks good.
So Donnie down there looking for the fall. I mean, hard to pin right here because of the angle. If she'd let go of that inside bar and kind of just slid, go chest on chest.
Just a little, yeah.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, though, watch. Emma Vanderhoof bounces right up, shakes hands, gives her a hug, says, hey, thank you very much. I'll see you again next year. Here we go. We're still trying to figure it out.
Are we shaking other hands or no? So.
It's all good. So we got another forfeit in the lineup here. It looks like we got Henry Girl from Athens at 126. Looks like that's going to be an uncontested weight by the Wolverines. So she's going to pick up a quick one there. So the next match is an interesting one for me. We got Hannah Rathman coming on. She's going to wrestle Sydney Rosenblum. Sydney is a first-year wrestler as well, daughter of Tanya Knowles Rosenblum and Jay Rosenblum. Also niece to Dr. Eric Knowles.
Dr. Eric Knowles.
We're going to see. I may be moving around a little bit here tonight watching this one. Sid and I watched the Penn State Lehigh match last Sunday. I don't know how much she picked up, but I know she's nervous, right? Like, this is the first time she's been on the mat here at home.
Get the foot on the line. There we go, Sid. All right. She's pulling the mic beard.
Yeah, nah, she's ready to go. We'll see. So, she got her head down. She's in a little bit of trouble. The Athens girl looking for a cradle. Let's go.
Cradle
right
at the beginning. Ooh.
Comes back to the cradle.
Comes back to the cradle.
Sid's got, she bellies out. She might have given up a cheap two there. Looked like there was a count. Yeah,
two,
there was.
Yeah.
So we got
see if she gets a base to come up. Look away from the half. Oh, that's a
half was deep.
Half was deep half.
All right. Well, there you go, kid. Sid picked up a W a couple weeks ago, so she's got her first win, but she's got her first home loss today, too. So keep on working, Sid the Kid. You'll be all right. Nice win by the Athens girl there. Very strong. Good half Nelson. Hannah Rathman. Very nice. Now we got Lily Sickler. She's going to face off with Braylon Wood. Watched Lily a couple times last week. She looked pretty solid, pretty strong.
She looked good up at Horseheads.
Horseheads,
she looked good.
Yeah, she seems to be figuring out the level changes and stuff pretty quick. See a lot of grandparents up there in the stands watching their granddaughters wincing and just wondering.
Well, I was hoping to see her grandfather last week up at Horsehead. So,
yeah.
Terp. Oh, maybe you're watching, Terp. Aunt Linda. Always try to get Lincoln to wrestle her dad, but.
Yeah. So they're in a pretty good position. They're working hand and head tie.
Stay in the center of the mat.
Yeah, good wide base by both girls. I mean, they're not going to get just pulled around or swung around. They got good stances.
Trying to get some good pass-bys through here.
30 seconds going in the first period. Both wrestlers just kind of feeling each other out. Donnie hasn't had to work too much with the pace on these kids. These girls aren't waiting. There's no stalling going on.
No
these
stalling.
Guys are going at it. I tell you, it's really, oh, there's a headlock
going
position.
For the head.
Back. Oh, wow. Interesting situation. Nobody. No control. Still no control. Here we are.
Is that hand in there? Arm in there?
I don't think she's.
Yeah.
We're neutral.
Yeah. Still that's neutral.
Good scramble by both girls. Shout out to Matt Talented down there, principal of the Wolverines. He's the leader on the floor down there tonight with the Wolverine crowd. Got Charlie Hughes is running the clock there. He's running a little. He's running all the electronics and stuff down there on the mat. We also got John Hogan down there helping him out at the table. So we want to thank them.
Ooh,
as she slides back
keep
into
going
that
headlock
situation.
Throws.
Wow, this girl's putting her head right in it.
It didn't. Oh.
I don't know if she goes.
That's illegal.
Is she going to get the two or not?
No.
I don't know. I mean, that's a tough call. Because you're on top, and then you lock it, right? Like, I get it. I mean, I get the call, and I think in that spot there, I definitely agree with Donnie in that call. But I saw it again last weekend, and it made me think about it. You come down, and you have the guy
not
exposed,
in
and you're not in the headlock.
Not in the illegal headlock position, but
then
you
go
clasp.
To it. So do you get the two and then the one? Or do you just give the one and put them both on their feet? So that's a
That's a tough call.
It is a tough call. Yeah, it is.
Pass by with less than a second.
Wow, 1 second left on the clock. She hits a beautiful pass by, puts Lily down on her face and spins. Athens going to take top. Lily's going to challenge Lily to get off on bottom here.
Let's get these first moves are going to be for off the bat. Excitement. Trying to guess that whistle.
A lot of moving. Well, you know, let's talk about the history of this match for a second, right? Like, I mean, this is the first time. Oh, don't talk about history. Lily says, I'm going to get me two.
And backs.
She's picking up backs. I don't exactly know what her pinning combination is. She's allowed to have that headlock like
there,
that.
She has
that
the position. Leg in. She has the leg in.
So she's pulling back. That's a Athens girl fighting hard there. But she doesn't have much.
Yeah.
So this match is going to go 5-3 now. Should be 2-3. Nah, they got the score wrong. The score should be 5-3. Score should be 5-3. Waverly, it should have been 2 reversal, 3 backs. So I'm sure coach will catch that. There you go. There's the scoreboard. They're always a second behind. Good job, John.
Right there, to see the flexibility on girls and women, like how much different it is.
Lily turned right into that and just kept on going. She's got a strong, you see the core strength there. I mean, she pushed, her technique's not great, but she's just got good hips.
She throws a leg in.
She's pulling back.
Think she got two back on. They got two swipes.
Yeah, she could jump over and get half Nelson.
She goes under the arms. Oh, man.
I tell you, the Wood girl's tough.
She's not giving anything up.
No, not at all. Bray Lynn.
Fighting right through here.
Bray Lynn,
get that arm through. Get that arm through.
That's 45 Bridge. Seconds. There's Bridge. Not much time. Hey, there you go, Wolverines. That's the first Waverly pin for girls wrestling in the history of Section 4 right there. So circle that one on your program, ladies and gentlemen. It's a historic match. Miss Holmes got the first win in the gym for the girls' varsity team in an exhibition. Lily Sickler gets the first actual dual meet win and the first pin for the Waverly Wolverines. I'm going to circle that one on my thing. That needs to make the news tomorrow. Newscast, let's make sure we get that to happen. All right, so we got a forfeit up here at 145 pounds. Paul, who we saw in the exhibition beginning, she says, I'll take this forfeit.
I'll take it, yeah. Freddy forfeit sometimes isn't a, you know.
She wrestled a tough match.
Yeah, that was a tough match earlier.
So we have no match at 52. Then at 165, it looks like Holmes is going to have a match, which is kind of crazy because she wrestled that full exhibition match earlier. And she's going to be back on the mat, so we're going to see.
I was going to say, how long was that? Half hour.
Just about right, I think.
25 minutes.
She's
getting that nice achiness tomorrow morning.
Wow. You know, yeah, she's
those muscles you
today.
Forgot that you actually had.
Yeah, she's going to be looking for a quick one today. I think I've got Wagner, maybe, from Athens. Like I said, this is anybody's guess is as good as mine when I check out coach's writing here. I know what she weighed, but I don't know what her name is. So here comes
Abigail Wagner.
Abigail Wagner. So we nailed it. We interpreted that hieroglyphic.
Abby Wagner.
Yeah.
Abigail. Abby girl.
Yeah, there you go. Here we go. Abby's not waiting. She says, here she comes. She's working ahead and arm tie. Trying to get that short offense going.
Oh, intense coming out here.
Yeah, these guys are going. So, and we saw in that first match, Pat, I mean, that she was right after that. She went right after the head. Holmes did. She's looking for that short offense as well. Get a snap down. 30 seconds, both girls still working center of the mat.
Yeah, Look at this. Athens bringing their cheerleaders and having the cheering for the girls. I love this.
Yeah.
Gym's packed. Everything's got everything going. The excitement. It's wonderful.
I was...
A lot of working position here. Oh, try to snap her down. Pummeling in.
I sent an email with a hype video to Craig Stage earlier this week, you know, the superintendent at Athens. Said, come on, Craig, let's go. I think maybe some of the people thought Craig and I were going to have a match. We're both probably in the same weight class at this point.
I'd wrestle them, too. That's okay. Yeah, I don't mind.
I think both of us probably, we're both going to have to hit the treadmill here after Christmas break, figure it out. Too much time at our desks. Not enough time out here doing great things like watching these kids go at it. 35 seconds left, 1-0 match. Waverly on top. Both girls staying in good position. I mean, they're forehead to forehead.
They're not ear to ear.
Yeah, nobody's really making a deep attack. They're just kind of, you know, feeling each other out, seeing if there's a single high single leg there that they can grab quick. But nobody's taking too many chances here. I think they both respect each other quite a bit as wrestlers are. And that's going to end the first period, 1-0. It's going to be Waverly in the lead here. It's going to be Athens' choice. Athens the first, Waverly. Waverly's going to choose the top position.
I think it's her first move,
I think it's a spiral rod. I think that's what she's coming out looking for. And
getting clear. She's getting clear. Abby girls up.
Remember, there was a good lift. She had a good lift in that third period.
Get away. Create separation. Where's the separation? Turn it in. Oh, got the skate.
There we go. We're 1-1. We're neutral. I just got a weird feeling this match is going to end up in a fall, though. It just feels like once they get going, they're really going to get going. It's been a good crowd tonight. I mean, they're getting into it. Sounds like a good wrestling crowd. People pretty fired up.
I love it. Off the corner, you see people jumping.
Yeah.
See all the excitement.
This is, I mean, and, you know, this is the beauty of Waverly Athens. It used to be Waverly Sarah, not so much anymore. But, you know, those Waverly Athens football games or basketball games or wrestling matches.
Wrestling matches.
Draw a nice crowd.
She had ducked under this.
Trying
to trip. Yeah.
Oh, there you go. Now she's in on her single. So Athens in on a single. She's driving. Waverly working for a sprawl. She's got
to. Trying to get her weight down. Trying to get her hips away.
Yeah.
Get that separation.
She's got a chest lock. Waverly's in a chest lock.
Chest.
Bad move. She had great position.
She had position. She did have the position.
She just went to her knees. I don't know.
Oh, now it's get that turn. 28 seconds left.
Wow, that's how quickly wrestling can change. In great position.
She was good position. I don't think she was going to get taken down.
No, she wasn't.
She fought off. She was fighting off the double.
Yeah, went down to her knees and just gave up position. Then it was trouble. I tell you what, gutsy performance here, though, because that's a deep half.
That was 30 seconds that she was fighting off.
She gives it up. She's close. Yeah. I tell you what, good match. You know, she's already got one W under her hat today. So she's going to go 1-1 on the night. But nice job. Good hustle by Athens in that match. Absolutely, Miss Abby Wagner. Nice job. Congratulations to her. Good half Nelson. She capitalized on that shot. And she getting helped off by her teammates.
Abby girl.
So
there you go.
I think both coaches got some sprints in the hallways tomorrow. Start working on that conditioning a little bit. So it's early in the season. I think we'll see the same thing with the boys. So we've got Lizzie Robinson. Lizzie, a standout swimmer for us, really coming into her own this season. I saw her at the section final, and she's got a forfeit tonight. They don't have anybody in that class, so she's going to put 6 on the board for the Wolverines. And then state champ for Waverly. Athens doesn't have anybody in that weight class as well, so we're not going to get a chance to see LaForest. For the first match of the year, be able to put her state title on the line. She did put it on the line up to Horseheads, and she looked pretty solid up there. So She's not going to be challenged tonight, which is too bad. Always nice, Pat,
always like
when
to
you
watch
see
matches.
Yeah,
especially when you have a solid competitor. People want to see them.
Yeah, well, you got the champ, right? Yeah. I mean, you don't have the champ on your mat all the time, and she is. She won that state title last year, and looking to defend it this year. So, all right, so we got a bunch of exhibition matches here. That's going to close out the varsity match.
Athens 42, Waverly 18.
So Athens is going to be a 42-18 winner. Got a good round of applause from the whole crowd. Really appreciate our girls, Athens and Waverly, bringing it to the table, or the mat, if you will.
The mat, yeah.
And we're going to go to some exhibition matches here before the boys come out on the mat, and we start the boys' event, which is scheduled to start at 7:30. So we're right on.
We're on time.
We're right on time. So we're going to see Lily Wright again. Lily got pinned in the first period in that first dual meet match that she had. She's going to face off against Galasso.
I thought it looked like Galasso. We're good.
So I think we know that name, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was Galasso. Boy wrestled there. Ridgeberry kids, right?
Ridgeberry, yeah. Her family, like dad's like he's Smithfield originally, and then
yeah.
Grandfather is Larrabee, Herman Larrabee.
Yeah, he was a wrestler for SRU back in the 60s.
Solid, yep.
Yeah.
Oh, nice shot. She works really hard. Since she was young, she always wrestled.
Has she?
Yeah.
So this is, Lily's just getting into it, but she's a scrapper. You can see she comes up to her feet. She was in bad position, but you know what? She's a Wolverine. They'll scrap with you. So she's trying to get her leg out. They go out of bounds. Score is 4-1. 4-1 Galasso. Wright comes back to the center. Wright kind of takes the measure. Galasso very aggressive. Getting after it. Galasso went on a nice deep shot.
See how she finishes this.
Single on the right side. Lily working. She gives up her hip.
Nice finish.
Yep. Galasso's going to pick up another two. She goes right to the head, right to that spiral ride. She's going to bump that with her hips. No quitting, Lily.
She has some experience of watching, like, her older brother and all the room. She'd always be there in the room.
Yeah.
Working with her.
She's going to run in
position.
Nice.
Yeah.
Tight. She ran that nice over the top. I mean, Lily's a tough kid. She's not going to give it up, but there wasn't anything there. Donnie Bowers hits the mat there. It's going to be fall for Galasso. So our next exhibition match is going to be Vanderhoof again. So you see most of the Waver girls are getting an extra match against Aurora, I want to say Beaver. I'm looking over at my tech crew. They're giving me shoulder shakes. I have no idea which ones.
Yeah, I'm just glad we're still on the mat. You know, you guys are doing good. We can actually see the mat still. So.
Aurora Beaver. All right, so we got Vanderhoof. She gave up a fall in that first match, her first in the dual meet. She's going to see Aurora Beaver here. So they're going to get after it. These are 2-2-2 matches. No difference between the boys and the girls' matches. Rules are the same. Periods are the same. Weight classes are a little bit. Actually, the weight classes look the same as well. So I think
girls were more spread out.
Well, I think we're wrestling PA stuff.
Okay.
PAs, I don't know. That's. I have a feeling when I look at that weight class breakdown that it's not the New York State Federation, but that's fine. A lot of times, historically, a lot of the times we have wrestled the PA weights up here in New York.
Especially 91 and 98 was always.
Yeah, so they would never wrestle. I mean, we were both Athens wrestlers, but we never wrestled the 91-pound weight class up here. All right, Emma's trying to work. There's a headlock. We got an illegal
headlock. Yeah, no arm.
Yeah, so that's going to get 1 point for Emma. So Emma's going to get on the board there because of the illegal headlock. She wants clarification from Donnie. Donnie says, get on the line here, young lady. Let's go.
I know that was always our controversy, coming up here and wrestling Waverly. If we'd start at 98 or if we'd do the 91, 98, and then trying to.
Yeah, there was
Look at those little 3-pounders. Say, hey, you gonna cut down 98 for us? Yeah, you know.
Yeah. The two weight class. It's funny that the federation can't streamline all the weights across all 50 states, but you know, you follow politics today, we can't really figure anything out. So why would we be shocked that wrestling can't come up with the same weight classes across the U.S.? So, all right, Emma's still working there solid. She's got good elbow control on the right side. I don't know if she's looking for an elbow pull. She needs to keep her head positioned. She's dropping her head a little bit. And that's exactly what happens. When your head goes down, your body will follow. So, oh, she tried a nice switch.
Yeah.
But she got hung up. She didn't get through on it. Athens girl doesn't really have much of a pinning combination. She's just chest on chest.
But if she grabs the claw right there, get the push it back on the elbow.
Emma's arm was trapped behind her back there, so. Good. So Aurora's going to, she takes the lead 2-1 now with that takedown. 2.5 seconds left here in the first period.
Wait for everybody yelling, short time, short time.
These guys don't operate like short time, man. They stay after.
Yeah.
All right, second period. We're going to go with the coin toss now because the dual meet's over. So Waverly has choice. Waverly's going to defer to the third period. Going to give Athens choice. Athens takes top.
Was that? Okay.
Yeah, she chose top.
I wasn't sure how.
Emma down. Yep, she's going to put Emma on the mat. I know Abby had dance tonight. She's like, I can't believe I have to go to dance tonight. I want to watch this match.
Oh. Last year when I came here, usually she was working the booth.
Yeah. There's one. All right. So now we're tied up.
Tied up 2-2.
2-2. Emma Vanderhoof with a good
stand-up.
Top of
the second period.
Wherever the coach is doing a nice job with that stand-up. That's second or third one I've seen from the girls. Looking good. Back into that. See, these guys are ear-to-ear here in their ties. Their ties aren't great.
Yep. Yeah.
Somebody's going to snap somebody down.
A little bit of pushing back and forth, trying to get a little leverage.
Ooh. Oh, there's a double. She's going body lock. She's trying to get that body lock and a good lift. Get a good lift in there. Come on.
Still trying to get.
Oh, Emma gave it up. Watch Roger over in my sound booth. He's not happy with that. He thought you should have had two there, Emma.
It looks a lot easier up here than it is down the mat sometimes.
Absolutely. Kids are working hard. 58 seconds left to second period.
Lots of things going through your head, especially if you just start the sport. You know what you're supposed to be doing or should be doing.
Yeah,
everybody's yelling at you.
She's back in position again. You're looking at it. She's reaching. Just now, I think we're running. We're getting a little bit close to an empty tank. This is Emma's second match again that she's done in the last 45 minutes. So, see the Waverly girls with a little bit of, you know, just tough, this mental toughness staying in it. But you see they're a little bit tired wrestling.
Looks like nice shot.
Fresh opponents from Athens.
Outside single, cut over to a double, finish it.
That's a good takedown.
That was a nice shot.
Yeah, Roy had a nice takedown there. Emma doesn't want to look into that half now, so she's going to have trouble.
Look away from the half. Look away from the half. Ooh, 4 seconds.
Emma's in trouble right there. She better come through, post on an elbow or something.
Ooh, yeah.
She survives the period. Gave up three backs.
She did get three, though.
So she's going to be down 7-2 going in third period, her choice. They're obviously either going to take neutral or top. Emma's going to choose top position. She's going to work for a spiral.
Short bar.
Yeah, I thought I just saw Coach. Waverly coach here saying, you know, spiral, I get that half up top. So.
Suck back. Oh, keep your head up. Oh, catches her on her back.
She rolled right to her back for her. All right, yeah, but she's only going to pick up three here if she can't get the fall.
Yeah.
And that's, she's still going to be down 7-5. So there's her three backs. Now he should
she's
release
got a deep,
those.
Deep half, yeah.
We bellied out. That's a different move.
Change position, change moves.
Yeah, this is. I do have an issue. Donnie's going to watch this later and be like, hey, Eric, you know, quit picking on me on the thing. But I think they're holding those points way too long. If you watch the college matches, those points come out.
They come out.
You know, once you roll back to your base, and that's like, see, we've transitioned.
That's a totally
twice
different. That's a total
to two
different
half Nelsons here. Like, we've fallen off the body. So that's, yeah, that's. I
disagree with that. That should have been much sooner.
That's but that is, you know, that's one of those things. It's I mean, I've officiated as well, and you're holding it. You're not sure when quite, you know what I mean? Are you still in it or you're not? But that's a point. All right, so we're 9-5.
50 seconds left. Fighting off their drive through. Ooh. Coach Wolkett tore her roll through. He softened that angle. Right back.
As she rolled through again, I don't think she gave up any points. I'll see if there were backs.
I don't know. He probably was
going to hold. I think he's still holding those
backs.
He'll
hold for 30. Yeah.
He's still holding those.
See, and this to me is totally different moves. This should not. He should have awarded those earlier.
Yeah. That's
20 seconds. Can she fight off her? And rolls through. Now she got some hand control. Gets to her base.
There you go. She releases the three. So that's going to make it 12-5. There's 10 seconds. And Emma just keeps rolling. She's like, I may have to nickname her Gator tomorrow when she shows up to school. She's doing that Gator roll.
Good match.
I tell you what, lots of courage, lots of guts. She's going to be sore tomorrow. No quit. Both girls, nice job by Aurora. Good quality win for her, 12-5 over Emma Vanderhoof. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we will preface this by saying this is the Waverly Wolverine News Network. So if you say, hey, what are those guys, a couple of homers up there? Absolutely. This is Dr. Eric Knowles, Superintendent of Schools of Waverly. I am a 100% Waverly homer, but I do appreciate all the athletes out there. So just for full disclosure. All right, so we've got an exhibition match coming up here. It looks like we've got Mary Henry, and she's going to face off against Andrews. So I got Tayana Andrews. She's a ninth grader. I don't have any real athletes. Oh, doesn't have their girls in this computer, so I don't know.
I'm not sure. I hate to admit that I don't know what year Mary is, but in true Ridgebury fashion, she's a second cousin once removed.
So Tayana's got to work up here. She's in a little bit of trouble. There's a half Nelson in there.
Oh, it's deep. Let's see her settle back.
I just see a very aggressive. The Athens girls just very aggressive.
Very aggressive.
I mean, they're going right for the fall. This is great for this young Wolverine team.
Oh, nice.
So Mary's going to pull the victory with a fall in the first period.
Nice.
Looking at 41 seconds. Nice job. Tayana Andrews, all right. This is a good learning experience for the Wolverines because, you know, they've just been wrestling each other. They've had a couple small competitions. But Athens has been wrestling girls for 3-4 years. And, you know, these guys know what they're doing. And I said this was going to happen tonight.
They had a tournament last weekend, I believe. I'm trying to think on that. We're Athens. I think they went down.
Yeah, they were downstate somewhere.
Downstate somewhere.
Well, I mean, I talked to Devin today, and, you know, he's like, what do you think? I said, we're going to get, you know, we're probably going to get schooled in this dual meet. But I said, you know, you got to start. So this is great for our kids to understand what it takes to be on the mat out there.
First section for girls dual meet.
Yeah, that's just exciting. Yeah. Let's go.
And look at the crowd.
So this is Lily Parker. Lily's a senior for us. She's been in and out of our boys and girls lineup for the last 3-4 years. She's not a rookie by any means. Great kid. Looking at several colleges. Maybe we'll continue to compete in college. Loves the sport of wrestling. She's got a brother on the varsity boys team. She gives up two here. She's down 2-0. Works up to a base. Try to get to her feet. All right, Lily's coming to her feet. There's one. All right, Lily gets one for an escape, Pat. So now what do we got to do?
Look at a good stance here. Let's get inside. It's a good stance.
Yeah, this is pretty physical inside right here. Athens girl is real physical inside. This is Wagner.
Is it Wagner?
Yeah, this is Wagner. That's what I have. And Wagner had that pinfall.
Yeah, I don't know if this is her though.
Yeah, that's what they got on the.
That's all they have on there.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna say the Athens girl.
The Athens girl.
She's up 2-1.
Oh, right down the front headlock.
Man, did you see the pressure she put on that?
They put that right.
She still has to cut the corner. There she goes. She's gonna pick up two there.
Have to get to a base, Parker. Get up. Oh. See, look at the excitement. Lily, the parents down the aisle on the mat.
Lily's trying to. Lily starts her senior season at home. That's a tough one, right?
Yeah, very tough.
But she's still a good leader on this team. She's got a lot of these young kids she talked into coming out. And, you know, Lily's been one of those kids that's been with us for 4 years. So, you know, kind of a trailblazer when it comes to girls wrestling here at Waverly. So if she hadn't been out there working with the boys the last 3 years trying to compete, we may not have lifted a girls wrestling team this year. So I've got Holmes. I can't believe Holmes is going again. This will be her third match. No. I think we're off the script. This looks like Wheeler and Wright. I was going to say,
Right.
Yeah, really right. And this is Wheeler from Athens. Wright got pinned in that first match. She was wrestling Kolsar.
Look at the just aggressiveness.
And then Galasso pinned her as well. So she's had a rough day.
Couple matches.
And she may be in trouble again.
But that three matches to come right back out.
Oh, yeah, she's a scrapper, man.
Look at that, less than an hour. Three matches in less than an hour.
Yeah, it's the other thing. I mean, the kids, they're on the wrestling team. They're coming to school. They're taking care of their grades. They're taking care of their business. I can't say enough. I mean, there's like 40 kids in that Waverly wrestling program. I know the Athens wrestling program has 35, 40 kids. Just, I don't know. I mean, it's...
My grades were always better during the season.
Yeah. Well, you're focused, right?
Focused, yeah.
Lily's fighting off her back here. She's trying to get to the out of bounds. She's
got a minute. Push out. Know where you're at.
Nice.
Know where you're at. Ooh, that's... reset. Escape, revert. At least one. All right,
yep.
Game one.
No, Donnie's been good on the calls. Like I said, I think he's been spot on everything. My only complaint, and listen, this can't even really be a complaint because he's been consistent the entire match, right?
The holding
is
the
that
backs.
He's holding the points. He's holding them in everybody, so it's not like he's throwing them and not holding them. You know, he's holding them for everybody. So that's all I ever ask as a coach or as an athlete is just be consistent on how you're going to do it. So.
Oh.
All right, drive on it. Score it. Oh, I'll tell you what, she's going after
it. She's going for it.
She says, I don't have much, but whatever I have, I'm leaving out here in this red and white circle. So. Reminds me of our fine broadcasting crew over there that just leaves it out there every day. Outstanding. Roger, Dodger, and Doherty. The A-team.
It's like not really setting up her shot, though. That's the problem. Like, not clearing to accept the shot.
She knows she wants to be on the legs, and she's just driving to get
there.
She's
trying to get in there, yeah.
She's going to give up two on the edge.
No. See,
she had both knees out. Waverly was completely out on that one, so. Time she covered it, it would have been points out.
Yeah.
I'm sure that Mr. White doesn't agree over there, but.
Well, he's not yelling too much from what I can see. So
his kids have competed very well today. So, yeah. All right, we got a 5-1 lead for Athens here going into the second period. Everybody going for a water break at this point, I guess.
That's acceptable. Or is that inhaler? I think
we may have an inhaler, so we may have. So we should be on an injury timeout. Yeah, it should have been an injury timeout, Athens. I don't know if they called that or not.
No, it doesn't look it.
Now, sometimes that's important because if she needs another one, then it's going to give red choice.
Right.
So, I mean, I realize it's just a high school exhibition match, but.
But you have to learn the.
Yeah, because some of these kids may wrestle in the postseason this year.
you know.
Run that half. Look at Lily Wright. Wow. Look at Lily Wright. Lily Wright says it's my turn.
If she goes reverse it's half, my turn. If she reverses the half. Yeah,
she says, I mean,
she's bringing it back in the reverse half.
Listen,
that shoulder. I want that shoulder here.
I tell you what, she was dominated moment entire first period. No quit, comes back, shoots a half, picks up three backs, down 5-4. Now she's going to throw that half again. Athens girl made a mistake by stepping over her.
Oh, I thought she was
put herself in trouble.
She did.
May get stuck right here. Lily Wright's got her in trouble.
I really thought the Athens girl was going to slink out on that side there.
Oh, come on. There you go. What do you got? That's got to be close, man.
It's 1:10 left.
That's close. I don't know. There can't be too much under there. Her head's lifted. Right there.
Oh, there you go.
But you can pin outside the circle now as long as you have 3 points in. And there you go, Lily Wright. All right, Waverly fans. That's a big W for her over Wheeler from Athens. And I tell you what, it's been a long day for that girl.
Back.
That's three matches. So
that was a comeback.
She was. I tell you, Wheeler was wrestling a great first period, up 5-1. Good shape, and then Wright went to that half. Nelson, look at you. See her talking to her coach over there. She's all jacked up. Good stuff. So I've got Vanderhoof again. I can't believe I got Vanderhoof again. That's not yes, it is Vanderhoof.
That's what it looks like. Looks like her.
All right. Well, you know what? I guess their coach wanted them to get a workout tonight because we've seen Vanderhoof three times tonight as well.
Then who is she wrestling for Athens?
She's going to be wrestling, looks like maybe Fulmer.
Fulmer.
I am undefeated against the handwriting here. The handwriting is undefeated against me. We got no takedown, went out of bounds just on the edge.
Worked some insights ties here.
We're pretty much on schedule. This is the last match I have on mine unless they bring that Holmes match back. And we'll go right into the boys. We'll do their warm-up quick, and then we'll do the lineups, and we'll get started on that varsity match.
I think that was just a Chloe Owens setup.
Yeah. We saw Chloe last week with the old Three Stooges setup with the double finger to the eyes. You need to do
right,
the nose
right
block.
Hook.
Yeah.
Right hook. That was
as she came off the mat last week after that's Coach Brett Owens' daughter from Morris came off the mat last week. She was so upset. I'm like, you won. What are you upset about? It's emotional. It's an emotional sport. You know, I mean, there's not many sports where you go out there and have to put yourself out one-on-one.
One-on-one.
Everybody's watching you. Everybody's screaming at you. You're trying to do stuff. Your opponent's trying to not let you do things.
It's just you. There's nobody out, no other teammate. Just you in front of everybody.
Yeah, there's going to be some soul searching tonight when these girls leave the mat. As Emma, this period's closing out. She's down 2-0. A lot of questions for themselves. You know what I mean? Am I working hard enough? Do I need to work harder? The kids that look at assess themselves, reflect, and decide that they really want to get better will show up tomorrow ready to go. Or they'll do some push-ups or sit-ups tonight before they go to bed. Maybe get up in the morning, get a run in.
Think about getting some hand control and some of the picturing the match.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard, right? You don't know what you don't know. I mean, most of these kids got a whole 3 weeks of wrestling, you know, so. You know, we go into the boys' match, I mean, we're going to see some kids that have been on the mat for 10 years, you know, so.
Or more.
Yeah, I mean, Connor Stoller's been wrestling since he was a little kid. The Hills boys have been wrestling forever. Robinson kid from Athens forever. You know. Both the Courtney kids have been on the mat for a long time. I mean, both teams seem to have a pretty similar style. They want to go to that power half. They want to go to the to get to the side, break them down, and run that half, run that spiral ride. Pretty good on the starts and stuff today.
Nice stand up.
There's good 1 point there. So we should have a 3-1 score on the board right now in favor of Athens.
Top of the second period.
Top of the second, Pat?
Top of the second.
Well, baseball now.
I'd throw that in there for you.
Yeah, I like that, man.
Top of the second.
It shows how diverse you are.
Yeah.
We could do some of our ball games. Here we go. Now she's we're in a scramble.
Right,
looks
there,
like Athens going to get the takedown.
Got the duck under, a takedown. 5-1.
She goes right to that half again. But she does. She's got her hips on the mat now. So.
Yeah. Trying to get that pressure right there. Keep the hips down for the Athens girl. Jumps off to the side for the half. Did you have any girls when you were wrestling in school?
No, we didn't have any girls wrestling. I mean, we had, when I coached in the early 2000s, we had a girl on our team when you were my assistant there.
Yeah.
Ashley Nolan.
Nolan, yeah.
She was a 4-year wrestler for us. Tough kid, you know. She did wrestling, and then about 10 years later, she beat cancer, you know. So kudos to her if she's out there watching wrestling somewhere.
I think Coach Buck's daughter, Southside.
Yeah.
She was always really good. Then the girl from Notre Dame that wrestled.
Fanning, yeah.
Well, the one girl from Notre Dame that ended up being like WWE wrestler.
The upper weight, yeah.
I mean, it's pretty. We had a couple girls who came out for our high school team, and I always felt bad because I don't think they were really welcome in the room. And it's great to see that they actually feel comfortable now wrestling in the sport.
Yeah, but you know what? This is big because the girls came to us last year and said, "Listen, we want to wrestle, Mr. Knowles. We don't want to wrestle boys." And I said, tell me about it. And they're like, nah, we want to wrestle. I mean, we think it's a great sport, but we don't want to wrestle boys. We want to wrestle girls. So that was what pushed us. Brandon McWinnie was a big push in Section 4, Tioga Center, state runner-up, and All-American for Stephen Stack, who's his wife, much smarter than he is one of our teachers.
Much, much smarter than
he is. Yes, absolutely. Yeah. But he's been kind of a driving force behind wrestling. Girls wrestling. He's got a couple of daughters.
He has two daughters. Yeah.
Yeah. So, you know, he was working with me, Josh Rowe, Tioga Center, Horseheads, Tommy Douglas, a couple other programs locally, and in order to get enough teams to be able to sanction the sport. So, again, first as we're closing out on the first ever
shot.
Dual
outside
meet.
Outside double at C.
Girls dual meet.
Can she finish it? Can she? Ooh, running. Look.
Oh, it's a Vanderhoof.
Good
look
defense.
At this. She's got it tight. Come on. Run that half, Emma Vanderhoof. Emma Vanderhoof, she's tight. She's tight. What a way to close the match out. Emma Vanderhoof, after taking it on the chin, two matches in her third match.
She
down
smelled,
5-1.
Smelled blood.
She went and got it. Oh, tough loss for Athens. Girl, there was a control of that
control
whole match.
Control the whole match.
Third period, but I tell you, that's the thing about wrestling. You hang in there long enough, you don't know.
You don't know. Anything can happen.
Wow. Hey, as they go across the mat, congratulations to all
great
these girls.
That fantastic.
What a really solid Athens team. Obviously, you can see Athens is a better team. I mean, you can see that as far as the experience and whatnot, but I'll tell you what, I wouldn't trade our Wolverines for their fight for anything. Young team going at it.
That's great. That's exciting.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a brief break, and then we're going to come back. right, welcome back to Waverly as we get set up for this boys match here that we got going on. Just finished off the girls.
I hope you tuned in for that because that was fantastic.
It was pretty awesome. Yeah. The Athens girls were victorious in the dual meet, 42-18. They wrestled a large number of exhibitions afterwards, and we had some really good scrambles in those last two. I may have to take my blood pressure pill again when I get home. Emma Vanderhoof with down 5-1 in the third period pulls off a pin, and just before that, Lily Wright was down big and got a reversal for a pin. So, the Wolverines, Athens definitely outclassed them all in all, but the Wolverines finished the match with two falls that were definitely barn burners. So I was pretty
smelled
excited.
Blood, got the Athens girl on their back, and
That was good. So
got in.
You want to run through the Athens lineup, and I'll talk a little bit about the Waverly lineup as we go through. So 102 pounds for Waverly. We've got two wrestlers weighed in. We got Drayton Decay, who is a seventh grader, and we got Riley Stotler, who is an eighth grader, weighed in at 102.
No, 102 or 110 for
– No, you don't have anybody that light. So one of those two kids will jump up. Drayton Decay is both these kids, Riley Stotler and Drayton Decay, have both been on the mat a long time. They're really young, but they started wrestling in diapers, right? So pretty tough kids. Up to 118 at Waverly, we've got Caden Bradley, who is a transfer in from Williamson. Came in last year. Nice kid. Had a couple of decent matches up against at Horseheads. And then we also have Nico Ray. Nico was in the lineup last year. He's an eighth grader this year. So Nico is a pretty solid little 18-pounder, been on the mat a long time.
So we have, is that 19? We have 118 ones there.
Mason
Vanderpool, 121, but he's 118. What's
the weight? The New York weights are
118.
Right here.
So Mason Vanderpool, and then 118. Joaquin Sinzabal was also 117.
Yeah, so he could make that weight class. He wrestled for them last year. His dad was a Waverly wrestler.
Waverly,
so.
Wayne, there you go.
Yeah, his grandpa's sits on the Waverly Village Council. So, I mean, he's going to –
Wayne.
He wears red and white, but he probably might be – he's definitely going to be cheering for his grandkid today. So, 126, we got Jake Biesecker, who weighed in at 26, and Josh Courtney is up from 118 last weekend. So, Jake's a third-year wrestler, started for us in varsity last year, had a tough season. I think he won 2-3 matches. Josh was a transfer student, so he had to wrestle JV last year. Did get into the IEC tournament because it's an open tournament for JV and varsity, and he took a third there, so he's a solid kid.
Yeah. Athens has Dalton Davis, weighed in, and Kaysen Sipley.
We got Bryce Van Dyke and Mason Hamm, both – pretty young kids. Mason's been in and out of the program. Brant's, he wrestled last night, started for us at 32 last night. Pretty inexperienced, you know what I mean? They're good kids. They'll go hard. We'll see what they do.
And Sean Peters for Athens at 132.
138, we got Seth Noto and Braden Nichols. Both are kids that were in and out of the lineup last year. Good kids, good all-around kids, football players, wrestlers, tough kids. So they're no rookies to varsity action.
And so at, what's that, 139? Wait, 138. Man, these weights are. So I'm sorry if I butcher this. Emiliano Melar?
I don't know.
It's Fragile. Must be Italian. So and Aiden Miller and Cooper Robinson.
Cooper's the one I know out of that because that's
AJ's brother.
Yeah. So he's a tough kid. He's a freshman this year, right? This is his first year up.
First year up.
All right. So we got at 45, Connor Stotler, Riley Pfeiffer, Parker Larson, and Hudson Sink. Your senior captain is Connor Stotler there, 7-0 on the season, fourth in the section last year. Parker Larson's had a couple of nice matches going forward, and Riley Pfeiffer, you know what? Riley's long. Hudson, good kid hanging in there. So that's kind of what I think you're going to see Stotler there.
At 45 at Athens, you have Jacob Courtney and Landon McGrath. Landon's Jason's nephew. I know he wrestled
Kale last week at my nephew up at Horseheads, Jake Courtney. So, I mean, both those are two solid guys at 45.
Yeah, probably the match everybody wants to see is Courtney versus Stoller. Yeah. I would imagine that's probably the matchup. So we'll see what happens with that. 52, we got Skyler Perry, Kevin Hollenbeck, and Dustin Gingrich. Skyler's been getting the start. He's a freshman, you know, first-year wrestler. So just out there getting experience at this point.
And 52 for Athens, Dylan Gallagher and Trey Souter.
160-pound Braden Hills is there. Braden won 28 matches last year at 152 pounds. But he's a pretty solid kid. He's, you know, he was originally came up through the Candor Spec program. Came over to us, I think, as a freshman, eighth grader. He's, you know, he's solid. I mean, he's going to be, as long as he wrestles and uses his head, he'll be fine. He was 4-3 last weekend.
At 60 for Athens, nice Ridgebury Proud, Keegan Cogdon matches. I've seen him wrestle. He's been pretty solid. I'm pretty happy with that. And Alexander Trowbridge.
So 172, we got Carter George and Nate Peters, both first-year kids here, football players, right? Just strong, athletic kids. Carter George is a big-time receiver this year. Nate Peters are looking to play inside backer next year. So good kids came out for wrestling, learned how to tackle, help them out with their football career.
And, Athens, we don't have a 72-pounder, it looks like.
189, you got Matthias Wells. Matthias is an eighth grader. I talked about him a little bit earlier. I mean, he's been wrestling a long time. He was went to Athens area up until this year, so that team knows him well. He's he had a nice tournament last weekend. I think he was 5-2 at Horseheads, so very young kid, you know what I mean? He does some things. Sometimes you shake your head, but then there's other times he does stuff and you go, wow, so this is going to be
good. Yeah,
you know, so it should be
both. He's always been one of those bigger guys.
Yeah.
You know? Even like now he's in eighth grade, but when he's even younger, I was always watching him working out with the older guys. Jonathan Tim from Athens at 89.
All right, so at 215, we got the other one of the captains here, Ty Beeman. Ty Beeman was section runner-up last year, went to the state, or section third, I think, last year. Got a wild card into the state tournament, picked up a match at the state tournament. So he's going to be backed up by Timmy George, but Ty should be a pretty tough kid in there.
That's the match we were talking about last year with Caleb Nason. Like, Caleb's only wrestled a couple years, and he's really come on strong, really working hard.
Great athlete. Like, no. Real great athlete. I mean, Ty was actually – I mean, like I said, it was eight. We were up for a major. I thought we were majoring him, and then he headlocked us out of nowhere, and he pinned Ty, and, you know, just things went downhill from there. So, match of the night. I don't know where we're going to start this one, but the match of the night looks like it's going to be Cam Hills or Troy Beeman.
And Josh Nittinger.
And Josh Nittinger. Yeah. I mean, I didn't have any fear of sending Troy Beeman out there. Troy Beeman went 5-2 at Horseheads. I mean, he's a freshman. He's going to bring it.
Yeah.
You know, Cam's a sophomore, and he's a full 285, boys and girls.
And, Josh here is 283.3. So, I mean, I know.
Yeah.
I think they wrestled last year, right?
They did. Yeah. They did. Cam's pinned him with a headlock last year.
But that was a close match.
Absolutely.
Josh, I know. I talked to his dad over the summer about that.
Oh, like, I know. Everybody wants to re-wrestle those matches, but once they're in the books, they're in the books.
Well, there are many matches I wish I could go back now.
Yeah.
So, especially against somebody local. That's the biggest thing about Athens and Waverly, any rivalry.
Oh, yeah.
It's not like, hey, there's somebody like, you know, a couple hours away.
People don't forget those matches. They don't forget them.
Then you see those guys around town and, you know, hey, if you have a brother like me, like, hey, remember when he beat you?
Yeah, you always have that, right?
Yeah, that's great. Thanks. Yeah.
You never live that stuff down. It always is around. Trust me, there's still a couple guys running around the valley. I say, hey, remember when? I said, yeah, I do. I do.
You have a lot less losses than I had, though.
So we're going to go down to the mat and see where we are in the match here. We've given you. Anybody out on the mat there? So Athens or Waverly's out there warming up. So as you see, a good number of kids in red and white out there warming up. Varsity boys look like they've got about between 28 and 32, depending on the day, and who's got flu and who's got S. You know, this or that or everything else. So,
are we starting at 38 then? Is that what?
I think that's what it looks like.
Looks
so,
like starting at 38.
So that's an interesting starting point because who's at 38 for Athens?
So that'd be probably Cooper. Robinson. Would he be at 38?
Yeah. So I imagine they'll wrestle Cooper at 38.
and then at 45, they'll go after Stotler.
And have Jacob Courtney in.
I mean, that's a match a lot of us want to see. So, yeah.
Just because we want to see it doesn't mean the coaches want to see it, though. That's always the...
You know, I don't know, man.
I'm always for putting the guy that you want, like, get the tough matches. Like, that's what you're here for. Get the competition in. Who really, when it comes down to...
You're wrestling for the end of the year.
Yeah.
You're not wrestling for today. You're wrestling for March or for February. Yeah. Depending on whether you wrestle in high school or college, right?
Yeah. End of the season, that's always been Athens. Athens Drive has always been not so much during, it's the end of the season, where they're going to put the kids in the postseason and how far they're going to go.
So if you look, there's a young man there with a leg brace on. That's Gage Tedesco. Gage Tedesco, four-year starter for Waverly. Number one ranked kid in and out of Section 4 last year. Had a knee injury about week 8 in the football season. Put a huge hole in our running game and our defense as a linebacker. So there you see Coach Sean Bradley, longtime coach for the Athens Wildcats. Come across the mat there. Devin Whitman and A.J. Aaronstam for the Wolverines.
Four exhibitions,
okay. Let's see who these guys are.
So we're going to listen close so we can figure out who's out there. This looks like it's a lightweight here. Sensabaugh's not going to be in the starting lineup. And Caden Bradley's not, so right. Bradley and Sensabaugh, there we go. Should be a pretty good match, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
Both these kids are going to bounce in and out of the varsity lineup this year, both good boys. Young, you know. I want to say that Sensabaugh's a sophomore.
Yeah, I was going to say I think he's a sophomore.
And Bradley, I think, is an eighth grader. So
Sensabaugh's trying to work inside. Grab. Oh.
Bradley with a nice spin there. That looks like two.
Yeah. See how long he stands. Right. Get some hand control and get up.
Yeah. Yeah, I saw the Bray. He transferred in last year. His dad moved up to, I think he's up in Lockwood or something.
And, stay on the mat.
Yeah. And I think his dad's coaching Pee-wees for us now. But I asked, I said, I always pick on kids when they come in. You a wrestler? And he says, yeah. He says, I wrestled for, I can't remember if it was Mansfield or Williamson Pee-wees. But he seems to know what he's doing out there.
Rough, riding tough on top, so.
Yeah, he just keeps his way up there.
Getting out front, though. See if Keaton capitalizes on this.
Yeah, good spins. Oh. Like I said, see, he's on the balls of his feet. He's just in good position. That's what I noticed last week on Horseheads. The match he won. He won that overtime match against Horseheads. Remember that?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a big match.
Okay.
So he just stayed in good position all the time.
Man, still spinning right behind.
So they're not running a clock for this match, so we're not really sure how much time's left in the period. Do know the scoreboards. They're not running the scoreboard,
either.
So we got 2-0 right now, Waverly. I'm going to keep track of this with my analytical mind here.
He's holding up fingers here. So.
Absolutely. I got my socks off. Roger's smiling at me over here. That's what you do, Roger. You take your socks off and then you put a rubber band on two toes. Just when you get a point, you
count.
Put another one.
Just keep it counting it over.
Yeah. That's the way we did it in the old days before we had cell phones. You guys wouldn't know anything about that.
Slide rules.
All right. We got a 2-0 lead. Waverly's going to choose down here in the second period. This is Caden. Had a good snap and spin in that first period.
First move off the whistle.
Yeah, I think he's going to get himself in the lineup. He just seems like he's...
His position is very solid.
Yeah, you see how he's not going down all the way to his base. I see a little more motion on bottom here.
Crossover.
Yeah, he should change that over.
Oh, don't go back down.
Maybe. We'll try to see if I can't get the lock in the hands call. Yeah.
Keen's working hard. Try to push down, get a nice half in there, jump off to the side.
Yeah, we may see this match again at the Jarvis tournament this weekend. Jarvis tournament.
Nets duels.
We just had a visitor come in here. Looks like Emma Vanderhoof just came through the door up here. Breaking in. Hope she put some deodorant on before she came up here.
Couple matches through. Come back with a pin.
Almost gave me a heart attack up here. That's good. Our AV team does a great job up here, Pat. I mean, these are all
every
student
year,
run.
Every year I come in here, I'm always impressed what you guys have here. I think it's amazing.
It's crazy. I mean,
I think it's better and better each year.
Oh, yeah. They're constantly working on stuff. Yeah. So Athens working tough on top. He's got a half and a wrist. Caden Bradley's not going over, but he's not getting out either. I mean, it takes a lot out of you in a second period just getting ridden out.
Just getting ridden out. That's not fun.
You know, I mean, he had that good stand-up at the end of the second period. Kind of gave it up by falling back to his knees. Not exactly sure. Like he was trying to sneak a locked hands in there or something. It's not the way to go get it.
And Keaton's working on that.
Wing down.
Get that. If he's set.
He's got it.
Get your chest. Oh!
Runs out of time.
If he reset his chest, he might have got a swipe.
That was tough.
So 2-0, right?
Yeah, 2-0. 2-0 Bradley from Waverly. It's kind of a, you don't hear that too often,
Bradley from Waverly. It's not a
common thing
that
we say. I mean, Athens is going to have to hustle a little bit. There's no stall calls here. Sets the ball. Yeah, he's down by two. He's got to get a shot.
He's got to get a better shot, though. But digs it up. Sucker drag out of that. Sucker drag right.
Bradley's still in pretty decent position. He's under that arm. If you look, he doesn't. He's got a lock on that tricep, so it's hard to drag that.
Dump.
Yeah, a lot of time going off the clock here as we're messing around with this. Although, there you go. He's building up nicely. Building up. Bradley's sliding with the laces.
Keeping his laces down, all that pressure right on his neck.
I like the fact that Donnie let them wrestle that out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? There was no sense in breaking that. I mean, Sensiball was still trying to build up. So we probably got about 45 seconds left in this. So Sensiball's got time for one more good shot. And there was
not that shot. Get up to your base. Get up to your base.
There you go. We got a good two there. Just keep your hips up now. Man. Finish your match. You're up 4-0. You know.
Don't step over.
He's in good position. He got to finish wrestling. Head stays up. He didn't put his. He put his head down and he put his elbow out. I tell you what, that's one of those things that drives you nuts. You're up 4-2, and. Maybe up 5-2. That may be illegal. You have two hands on that.
Meaningful now.
But if I'm Coach Whitman right now, I'm losing my mind because I want Caden on his feet. And Sensiball's just got to get to that half right off the whistle.
He's got to get a turn. Quick turn here. Get three. He's driving it.
Yeah, this is just a very dangerous place for the Waverly wrestler to be at this point in the match.
Sensiball gets off to the side.
Short time. I'm guessing.
I wish we could tell you the time.
All right, so he's going to take a 5-2 victory with that penalty shot.
Yeah. I'm watching Twitch World Cup.
Yeah, that's a good win. That's a good win. Like I said, nice wrestling for the most part. Couple little things there. You know, like to see him finish out those periods a little bit better. Don't get held down on bottom. that may come up when somebody sees him in the hallway tomorrow. So he didn't have his headgear, so now we're trading headgear over there. I know they're in the budget, so obviously somebody
left
theirs.
It's a line item.
Yeah, it's a line item in the budget. Miller?
Aiden Miller. That must be a 39.
So we got Seth Noto, who's our backup. So that looks like we're going to see Brayden Nichols at 38. I like Noto. I mean, he's been around for a while. I think, when I say a while, he wrestled last year. He wrestled JV last year, but nice kid. Good hustler, polite.
Got some change of elevation there going on.
Yeah, I think he's going to be okay, right? Like, I mean, he's a sophomore, so he's still figuring it out.
Let's see, finishes this.
Oh. I mean, that's the one thing last year when I watched him wrestle. He wrestles hard. Not always wrestles smart, right? But he wrestles hard. And he doesn't quit. There's no quit in the kid, so you can do a lot with that when you're coaching a kid.
Got a gut wrench block.
Yeah. He was just in a bad position. Once he lost his hips, he wasn't able to do anything. He'll be careful to reach back there. A stalling call there. He didn't make a move to take him to the mat, so that's going to be a stalling warning on Athens. That's not going to be a big deal, I don't think, right now. It might be in the third period. So there we go. He gets his hands in the pocket. He's going to try to get his one.
No,
why?
No,
he keeps reaching back for that. That's something Coach Whitman's going to have to go back and say, what? Boys, let's reflect on this. What exactly were we trying to do here? I mean, they do all that work in a beautiful escape position and then fall down on their knees. There you go. Seth's got good position there. I mean, all you got to do is clear his leg. He's got one. There you go. Just keep circling. Time's got to be short, though. Got to be short time.
Some inside ties. At least they're head-to-head.
Well, once again, we want to thank Charlie Hughes down there running the show on the computers down there on Matt's side, along with John Hogan, who's running our clocks. We appreciate them. Matt Tauta and the administration for being here supporting Waverly Police Department. Just because it wouldn't be an Athens-Waverly wrestling match without having a couple police
officers on site,
right? Yeah, as we continue this match here, you know, we lost, I saw in paper the other day, longtime advocate for Waverly Wrestling, Jerry Ruweed Sr. Passed this week. We want to send our condolences on to young Jerry, who was one of our coaches for a while here. Always pops in the room when he's around. Coach Weed, you know, was good about making sure the kids got anywhere they needed to go. If there was a fundraiser, he did it. Oh, as we look, as Noto Perry says, Mr. Weed, Coach Weed would be very happy to see this red and white on top of the Wildcats. There's no doubt about that. And that position... Ooh.
Wow.
That ends in a fall right there, so Noto capitalized. He capitalized. So did you get a chance to get over there today?
Yeah, I went, that's one of the reasons I was late, went to the viewing for
that.
Went
to the viewing, yeah.
So I always think of there are certain people when you think of when I think of Waverly, Waverly wrestling. So like between McClough, Mr. Weed, you know, you have all
Charlie
these
Hughes.
Charlie Hughes.
And to me, Andy Ehrenstam, you know, was another one, longtime coach there, is coming up the youth.
So who is this?
This is Pfeiffer here. He's got some style. He's dancing as he comes out there. This is Riley Pfeiffer.
You might want to get on the.
Yeah,
there
he didn't
we
get
go.
Much action okay. at the last meet, so he's ready to go. Riley is great. Riley shows up with a kick. Oh, look at that single. Right into a double. And a lift. Oh, man, he had great position, and he lost it. Oh. Riley's a great kid.
Out of bounds.
No points. That's a good call by the official. There was nothing really there. So Riley shows up during football season. I see him on the sideline with a camera. And I said, Riley, what are you doing? He says, I want to be a photographer. I said, okay. He says, so I'm the official photographer for the Wolverines. I said, how did you get that job? He said, I just kind of showed up with my camera. Well, I said, we got to get you a T-shirt. So if you see Riley, he's got a T-shirt saying official photographer.
Nice job.
He's got a good feel. I mean, there's been a couple of times he's shown real good feel out there. Tied up 2-2.
I'm glad to see we actually have the clock working now. Must be give the shout out to Charlie Hughes. So
it was a shout out down there, absolutely. So Riley's in a position where he could bury a deep half if he wanted to get out to the side and do it.
Trying to like a
Riley.
Was he going to half bar there? Is that what?
You know, he's been training this summer. He wants to kind of get into MMA fighting. I got a couple of these guys that want to do that. So grappling is a big component of MMA fighting. So there he goes, bar and hook. I mean, half and
if he reverses the half.
Yeah.
The cradle. So you got the Navy. You got the Navy ride going on.
He's got a bottom leg cradle by the looks of it. Yeah. Maybe. I don't know.
Should have gone Navy ride.
We're not going to talk about Navy. It's the Army-Navy game this week, and we're not going to mention Navy.
Not mention Navy.
Yeah. So we got a locked hands. Free move. Waverly. And he may take advantage of it. No. So 20 seconds left here in the first period. That's going to make it 4-3 in favor of Athens. Riley Pfeiffer on bottom in what's been a pretty entertaining bout up to this point. I don't know. I'm going to miss my bedtime tonight by the looks of it. My producer keeps looking at me like, you're on the clock. Keep working.
I thought I got a promise of dinner with this interview here.
Yeah, it's dinner. It's leftovers at my house.
What's Melissa making?
Melissa, I think, is playing bingo with diversions tonight.
Really?
Yeah. She's a huge supporter of me, and you know, she says I'm going out to dinner with the girls. All right, Riley, we got
4-3,
third period. We're on the line. Takedown's going to either put one guy ahead by two scores or the other one's going to change the lead. Ooh, Riley, not exactly.
Not the good snap that he's looking for.
Not exactly. That must have been. I don't know if Coach Whitman shows that like that. If he does.
You might want to have to talk to him.
So Riley gave up two. He's going to give up backs here. So he's going to need a big comeback if he's going to get back in this match. So we got a score of 6-3. Riley gets out. 6-4.
6-4. Get a takedown.
7-3. Oh, they gave the takedown to the wrong person, but should be about 9-4.
Okay,
yeah.
That's a little better.
It was a 5-point
okay,
move.
Okay, I was going to say, all right.
So we're still neutral. So a 5-point move puts you back in the game, ties it up at 9. I know a lot of people are probably watching this at home. I mean, there's been a lot of flu and stuff going around, so hope everybody's staying healthy. And you know, our hearts go out to the Madison family. We got some folks struggling with some medical stuff here, and we got some kids on the team that are directly affected by that. So, you know, hopes and prayers go out to Lisa, one of our teachers here, she fights with her stuff, so keep her in our thoughts. Got a fight to get up here. Don't turn into that cradle. Time's flying right now, Doc Pat.
45.
Oh, he's in a tight nearside cradle.
Got that's going to
pretty much going to end Riley's chances here unless something crazy happens. I mean, he did some nice things in that first period.
First period, he looked good.
You know, and
a little inexperience.
Well, you know what? Sometimes when they're young, they wrestle, and then they decide they think they know what they're doing. So they – we were saying there last weekend, I kept saying, that's, you know, that's not a move. It's not a move. So we got 10 seconds left here, 14-4. Pretty solid commanding lead for Athens. Riley's going to try to get a last ditch takedown, and he does.
Got the reversal.
14-6, and he's cooking. He's going for the half.
Yeah, nice.
Finishes off the period. Well, finishes the match down 14-6, driving for a fall. So we'll take that. Good character, Riley Pfeiffer.
Now it's the third period.
Oh, we're in the third period now.
Wow, yeah.
Whoa, man, that's been a lot of action.
That's
a lot
of
points,
action.
A lot of action.
Stand to the arms.
Mr. Hogan faked me out by going third period early.
So if Athens can keep his arms
I wonder if Riley can run that.
Keep his elbows in.
Wonder if Riley can run that.
Look away from the half. Look away from the half.
No, look into the half. Look at the half.
Oh.
Good defense by the Athens wrestler. Pfeiffer, though, he's going to come the other side.
Those elbows are just popping
right
up. He's
the other side.
Those car doors.
Oh, he's got it. He's got him turned. Riley Pfeiffer's got him turned. He's got the fans on their feet. He doesn't have it very tight, though.
No.
He's going to pick up three, but he's going to give up. This is,
Throw the legs in. Get the
legs. Oh. There we go. He's only going to give up one. So he only gave him two back points on that, which I don't know if that was the right scoring on that. He was definitely on his back for 5 seconds.
He should have had five swipes, definitely.
Yeah, so. Pfeiffer reaches in for the single. Now he chases off double. He got a roll through. It's going to be a scramble position. Riley sits a little too long and just gives up the takedown there.
Is he hurt?
I don't know. He just got a takedown. Now he's got a takedown. We're going half again. Riley's going to drive it over.
He's got 30 seconds. Needs the
pin. He's got 30 seconds. He better get moving. He's got back points. They're doing swipes over here. He's getting swipes. He's got terrible position, but he's getting swipes.
If there's no pin, you better
let him now
up.
He's got better position.
Oh!
Riley breaks. This is an exhibition match.
Wow.
He brings the Wolverine den to its feet.
Wow.
Oh, I love it. I just saw some guy in red and white jump through the roof up on about the 12th row up there. Oh, what an exciting match. Down 17-10. Oh, and he's going to pound his chest a little bit. You know what? Why not enjoy it? Let's go. Oh, beautiful. I tell you what.
Some exciting matches.
These are exhibition matches. It's crazy. So that looks like young Mr. Holland back there coming out for us. So he's a 52-pounder.
Souders.
God's country, baby. I love it. We just had Hollenbeck flexing his coach.
Yeah.
Oh, man. You know what? Why not? Why not? You
Wolverine
work your butt off all week in that room. This is your day to shine. Enjoy it. Make it a show, baby.
He's driving hard.
Oh, I don't know what Coach Grego would have done to me if I did that.
Yeah, I was going to.
I don't know. You know what?
That doesn't Grego mean, or Jarvis.
Old times doesn't mean they were better times, you know. So that's a good takedown by Hollenbeck right off the bat there. And he's looking to get some pressure out front. We got a full Nelson there maybe?
Is it pulling the headgear? I'm not sure.
Yeah, I think that's probably what it was, Pat. I'm not sure what that was all about.
I thought he was going neutral.
I don't know. I don't know what exactly we were doing there, but
I'm not touching him.
Yeah. You got some young wrestlers. You're not exactly sure what's going to happen. Hallenbeck wrestled on our modified program last year, so.
Okay.
He's not very old. He can't be much more than a freshman, I don't think. I mean, he's got good size. He's going to be a good kid. Ninth grade. So, I think he's out Shimong way. He's a good kid. Tough kid. Who's the Souter on bottom?
Mm-hmm. Souter.
Yeah. So, is that Cody's kid?
Sure, Trey. I'm not sure.
So, kind of a tough situation here right now for Souter on bottom. He's on his hip. Starts to work himself up. Waverly kids have been really pushing hard on the half Nelsons. I mean, most of our success has come with the half. Good call us for another point. This is how you learn. Although he does it one more time, it's going to cost him two, and he's going to throw him out of the match. He's not going to be flexing then.
You got to watch those full Nelsons.
I think he's got it that time. That looked pretty deep.
Looked a little deep there.
So Hollenbeck's got half
rolling
Nelson
through, keep
in.
Keep rolling. Get that arm clear.
Hollenbeck settles it back there. That's going to be pretty tight
right
there.
Get that arm clear.
Yeah, Hollenbeck's.
That look, he's got 25 seconds. Let's see.
That's pretty tight. That's going to end that. Yeah, these guys are jacked up, man.
Fired up for this.
Not only do you have the Wildcats in the house, but, you know, you got your first home match. You got your first girls match.
It's all exciting.
He's got a lot of firsts. These guys are they're ready to roll. You know, they're like, hey, let's go.
Oh, we got the lineup already. That was four matches already.
Yeah.
That was exciting.
Very exciting. Riley Pfeiffer down 17-10. Match is over, and then he comes back and gets the fall. National Anthem. We're going to take a break so you can listen to the National Anthem and the lineups.
Tonight's starting lineups. We will start at 138 pounds. Wrestling for the Athens Wildcats, we will have Aiden Miller, or Cooper Robertson. For the Wolverines, we will have Brandon Nichols or Seth Godel. For 145 pound weight class, we will have Jacob Courtney, Emilio Millar, or Landon Durant. For the Wolverines, we will have Connor Stotler, Riley Pfeiffer, Parker Larson, and Hudson Singer. Up next at 152 for the Wildcats, Dylan Gallagher and Trey Souter. For the Wolverines, we will have Skylar Perry, Kevin Hollenbeck or Dustin Gingrich. Moving on to 160, we'll have Keegan Carvin and Alexander Trowbridge. And for the Wolverines, we will have Braden Hills. At 172, we will also have Carvin and Trowbridge again for the Wildcats. And for the Wolverines, we'll have Carter George or Nate Peters. At 189, we'll have Jonathan Tim. For the Wildcats, for the Wolverines, we'll have Mr. Matthias Wells. At 215 for the Wildcats, we will have Caleb Mason. And for the Wolverines, we will have Ty Beaton or Tim George. At 285, Joshua Hittinger for the Wildcats. And for the Wolverines, Troy Beaton or Big Cannon Hills. At 102, we will have Drake McKay, who will receive a forfeit. For the Wolverines, at 110, we will have Riley Stotler, who will also receive a forfeit. 118, for the Wildcats, we will have Mason Vanderpool. And for the Wolverines, we will have Caden Bradley or Nico Ray. At 126, we will have Keaton Sensabaugh and Casey Sipley for the Wildcats. For the Wolverines, we will have Jake Biesecker or Josh Courtney. At 132, Sean Peters for the Wildcats. And wrapping up for the Wolverines, we'll have Brant Van Dyke or Mason Hamm. Let's have a great match. Coaches and captains, please report to the table.
We'll find out if he does the second man.
So the Wolverines win the coin toss. We're going to find out. It's going to be Athens' choice first. So Athens has odd-numbered matches.
All right.
They're going to have to send out their wrestler first here at 138 pounds.
Has chosen the odd matches.
Which is weird. I would have thought. Oh, no. That's what they wanted. Yeah, because they want that match between Courtney and Stiles on 45. Yeah. Which is the match? You know what? Let's have it.
Yeah.
Cooper, tough kid with an impressive junior high and youth experience. Brother wrestling at Lehigh, state champ for Waverly as a freshman. Transferred to Athens and state place finisher for Athens. Real good wrestler.
National qualifier.
Yeah, qualified for nationals last year. EWLs. Goes slide by right off the bat. Doesn't quite get it. What was Cooper's weight weighing in? Was he a heavy 38?
No, he's a 33.
I was gonna say he's a pretty small 38 pounder. They're circling in, looking for control. Forehead to forehead. Robinson aggressive, shoots him out. Waverly, a little bit of a skip step there on the way back to the center. And watch out for that old mat snake out there. Gets you every time.
They sneak up on you.
Yeah. So, Robinson with that big overhand.
Nice pass.
Big overhand club.
Cuts cross, reaches cross, grabs second.
Nichols goes shin
covers
wizard.
Covers off the, grab the far ankle.
Nichols was looking like he was going to go shin wizard up.
Split the crotch.
Yeah, here's the key. I mean, Cooper's got a lot more experience. Been wrestling a long time and at a pretty high level, right? So Nichols needs to keep moving, right? Just keep moving. If he can give up a three-point decision in this match, give himself a chance to be in the match in the third period, that's great. What Athens wants to do is come out here,
and, you know, see if they can't get a quick six and put it up on the board. So it's going to be interesting watching the strategy here. They call this one on Cooper, say he jumped a little bit. I don't know, looked like a delay whistle maybe a little bit. Now, Braden's a pretty strong kid. I mean, Cooper's undersized, so I don't think he's going to physically manhandle him. But
just use the technique. Yeah. Whenever it's someone stronger, better skill, like, just use your technique. And
yeah, very slick Cooper is. I mean, obviously, Athens fans have been waiting to see him for a long time come up and hit the varsity mat, so he goes for that tilt.
There, see, those are the things you don't want to do.
Yeah, you can't.
Can't make those silly mistakes like that against someone with skill. Yeah.
So he comes through.
Well, he came through out.
Yeah, I don't think he gave up three. I think he gave up two on the turn.
Two?
Yeah, two. So that could have been worse.
That could have been a lot worse.
You know, I tell you, he could have stuck him if he was. I mean, he had that. Yeah. Fouled it up. Beautiful. So Brady's doing a nice job. Just taking his time, right? Cooper's looking for opportunities here. He's going to cut him maybe. Nope, he's going optional start. So I was going to shove him away. It's kind of an Athens thing.
I was
going to
say, he's in Athens' room.
Yeah.
He's a
coach. It's kind of what they do.
Bradley on your feet.
Well, we said, listen, they won a lot of matches that way. A lot of state qualifiers, a lot of state place finishers. Still think you got to be able to wrestle all three phases, though.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of not everybody wrestling the same style. So.
Yeah. So I think Sean's got a lot of his kids home. You know, I mean, I saw the Horton kid win the RIT tournament.
Yeah.
Past weekend. Nice reshot.
Finished
by Cooper.
Up through. They drag it. Stays in position. Don't not give up the. That was nice.
Wow,
not
I
give
tell
up
you,
that.
Yeah.
That was good.
Oh, and it's good defense, too, by Braden. I mean, he almost had the opportunity to get the angle. I saw Austin Lamb from Tioga Center. Won that RIT tournament as well. So the Athens and Tioga kids showing well, collegiate level.
I mean, Caden had a fantastic year last year. Kind
yeah,
of
I mean,
bad call. He should have been a national champ.
Yeah, that was tough. I mean, it was all the controversy over that match, and then you realize that kid's, you know, he's an Athens kid, you know, and here he is in the middle of a national championship controversy. Yeah, I think that's a good call. I don't think that's stalling. I think you run the guy out. You could actually call it the other way.
I mean, Caden was one of those kids you just watch get better each year. High school, college, just kept getting better and better.
Yeah.
I mean, you're that controversial final match, but you had your national championship. See if Cooper digs this up out.
This match is kind of going. I mean, obviously, where we don't want to give that takedown up, but this is not
the blowout that I was.
If he keeps his head up and keeps standing. I mean, Cooper's has a little bit of problem with his size. It looks like he can't just muscle him over, so he's really got to look for opportunities. Now there, he's got that inside.
That's tight.
He's got that claw. But he's running out of time. That's that size that differential a little bit. So, good period. I mean, it's 6-1. Cooper's definitely in command of this match. Braden is, you know what I mean, looking for opportunities. Had a chance to score on the edge in the second. They're going to go neutral. Now, Braden wants to extend this match. Stay in good position.
We're trying to grab the rush in there.
You know.
Cooper just keeps working straight in. Nice. Always go for it. Oh, nice pass by.
Yeah, but see, and that's
it.
I mean, we need a better
there.
Sprawl. Yeah, we need a better sprawl on that. I mean, he's going to give up the two right here. Yeah. Now, but good. Go to your base. Buck up.
Don't
get
reach
back,
back
to your feet. You know, use your brain.
Cooper's got
to
move up.
Yeah, Cooper's trying to keep that leg trap back there. Keep your head up.
They want to get the major, though. That's the.
Well, yeah, they need a major here, and they're close.
He's going to get it if he doesn't.
Yeah, there's nothing there yet.
Well, there we go. There's your swipes.
Man, those are close, man. I don't know.
Throw a half.
Yeah. I mean, there's two. It's a good roll.
It was a good roll.
Good set. All right, here's going to pick up a couple more.
Like, yeah, he might get pinned on that if he doesn't move off his back.
All right, now he's sitting there. Let's see. Now we're transitioning. We're throwing points.
Yeah.
So
now I have to try not to get tucked.
Yeah, well, that's it. Yeah, that's the thing. They need bonus here. They right now they're setting on one. That's it for everybody watching here. You know, I once in a while we'll get a call that, you know, hey, your guy wasn't neutral on the call. Well, I will inform everybody that this is the Wolverine News Network. It is not the NBC or CNBC or anything else. So you are getting a Wolverine perspective here. You know, try to call. You know, appreciate
Wolverine lean, huh?
Yeah, well, absolutely. Absolutely. But they try to applaud all of our athletes as they're out there. But if you want a totally fair and unbiased call, you're probably not going to get
there
it.
We go. Let's see.
I'll tell you what, he may get the ball right there.
Break it, break it.
Now, see, here's the thing. He's got to get out to his base. Get out to his base. Keep that arm. Can't give that arm up again. Can't give it up. And he's going to, no. Roll through.
Roll through.
Two. There you go. Good fight.
That was.
Good match by Cooper Robinson.
Yep.
Good fight by Braden. That's going to give Athens a four-point lead going in. Give Cooper his first W up in New York State as a high school wrestler. So, I think you got to come, right? Right?
Yeah, go
you
for gotta it.
Come,
go for
right?
it. That's it.
It's a big match right here. I'll look at you. Start the controversy already. Waverly stepped out. Athens stepped out of the mat.
First.
They stepped out of the mat, so they're supposed to. Once he steps on the mat, he's supposed to stand on the mat. Sean Bradley grabs him.
Sean,
get back there.
Then Sean's like, what are you doing? He's on the mat first.
Yeah. Sean's going to watch this match, too. Yeah. This is the match.
All right.
So we got Courtney versus Stotler. You can hear the energy in the gymnasium just picked up. Yeah, these are two of the premier wrestlers in the region, and we're going to get the match, boys and girls. Sal Courtney's brother, longtime starter for Virginia, University of Virginia. Ah, there's a nice two. Connor's got two, and he's got a deep half. That's a deep half.
Yeah.
He's going to lose it, though.
He's
going to
lose it. I was going to say, if he runs that, he's definitely.
I tell you, you know, and Courtney is funky, but so is Connor. Anybody who knows the Stotler family and Ethan and the historical, they are a funky family, man. So you got two wrestling, big time wrestling families that got the middle brothers going at it right now.
And my nephews have been enjoying working out with the Courtneys.
Yeah. They're all
definitely.
Good kids, right? Like,
Well, both of these families, like, I don't know, both these families are great.
Absolutely. Great. Well, we're going to see Jake's younger brother, Josh, in that red and white singlet here in about 45 minutes. Big lift by Connor. Connor, very strong. All-state football player as a backer. Physical athlete. Said before, older brother Ethan was section champ, state place finisher.
Wow. Now that's strength right there with one arm.
Yeah, he's a tough kid. I've been impressed. The way he wrestled at, he had that one bad matchup at Horse Sense, but he ended up coming back winning in overtime. But he's... he's got to get a lift attempt in here, and he does. He looks to improve. 40 seconds, scores 2-1. I see what both these kids do, and I've seen them do over the years, is they have a tendency to put themselves in bad position because they're so funky.
They're so funky. I think you get out of position and then try to fight back from there.
Well, they think
but
they
then
can
they
do
score,
anything.
But then you can score from
but
there,
they can
too.
Score, too. You know, I mean.
Big, the risk-reward, the risk-reward.
Coaching the Stotlers for years, I'm like, do we have to give up five before we get started? What's going on? That's a nice takedown.
Yeah, takedown. Can we get a reversal before he gets nine? It's cover right there.
Scooch. Now, should be moving up on the body. Yeah. That was allowed to hold there for 12 seconds. Not yeah. sure about that.
Yeah, that was a little...
Yeah. But way to finish the period by for Courtney. Now, I think that Connor wrestled, the boy who graduated last year, coach's kid. He used to be coach for Cher, Scott Setzer's boy.
Oh, okay.
And I think that was a good match last year.
I felt so, like, at the end of the season, we got hurt. He was a great kid. Wrestled tough.
Yeah, he did.
You'd never like to see injuries, especially end of the season your last year.
Oh, yeah. Now, he got hurt in sectionals, didn't he?
I think it was sectionals.
Yeah, I think it was sectionals. Yeah, it was. So, Stott, we're riding on top. Just tough, hardcore ride. I mean, this is the kind of stuff you're trying to wear somebody else. You can score in the third period. Stott really needs – he can give up one this period. Courtney really doesn't want to give up two.
Courtney's getting a base.
You know. Stott has cross wrist tilt hooked up. I don't think he wants to do it.
I would not want to, yeah.
He's going to go to that three-quarter. Hey, you know what? He had two turns with that. I like the three-quarter.
Really?
I like it into a near side cradle because a lot of times the guy will turn into you and get out of it.
Is there a grappler? Or,
You just got to be able to use all your tools, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you just ate 15, 20 seconds up. Kid can't do anything. What's your offense? What are you going to do?
Stalling. There we go. Yeah. That was a good call.
Yeah, you got to take him to the mat. Or at least make an attempt. I think he'll cut him here. Oh, no, that's a pick. Oh!
Oh!
They're out. That's a good solid call, but
risk reward.
Yeah, risk reward. There you go.
Risk reward.
Right back to what we said a couple of tumblers. A little jump.
That's going to call jump a little caution on there.
That's a big 32 seconds right here. Going to the Grammy. I tell you what, I've watched this kid for years, and he kind of possums till the last 30 seconds, and then, man, he hits a nice move, gets a big score. Nah, he doesn't have to ride him for long.
He's got to try to get out. See reverse Grammy back through.
Yeah.
The funk the leg.
Austin's gonna just get stuck in trouble.
Oh! That's tight. 3 seconds.
Should give up that.
You got some bat, yeah.
Three. See, that's what we're talking about. Like, there's no reason to do that. I mean, you calm down, you're in a 5-2 match, you get one,
get
you take down, it's 5-5.
Hey, you Gramby me, watch me.
Yeah, but that wasn't even Gramby. It was a somersault. You know, I mean, it's one thing if it's Gramby. So now you got to fight your way back. You should have been it. Right now it should be down by two, and you're down by five. So it's just that's the difference between being a state champion and being a good local wrestler. All right, now you got to watch because Connor is funky here. He's got some leg cradle actions. Look at he's gonna start to.
He almost had the leg cradle.
You know, but
I don't know with the Courtney's.
He just put himself on his back. Courtney just put himself on his back. There's the takedown
to the back. Say with Courtney's with her funk, that was gonna be not gonna be something you really want to go through.
So he's going to have to come up with a turn here. I mean, it's too much to play. Take him down, let him up at this point.
Yeah,
because you're going to trade. You don't have enough time.
You don't have time for that.
Connor's tough on top. You know, he's going to get physical.
Yeah,
you're going to see how far the referee's going to let him go here pretty soon.
He definitely has more physical attitude now coming through here, but it's like he's got to turn him.
Yeah. Yeah, you're going to see it be pretty physical.
Because he hasn't had a really good solid turn. Really, he's had some close off of these.
Peterson. Connor needs to get his hips up. He's
not right yet. I mean, as long as he doesn't give up near side. Sit through that. Sit through it.
All right, you got 30 seconds. Something big.
Got 5-7. We've got 5-6. 5-6. I'll tell you where he had you. See, this is where giving up that 5-point move. You give up a reversal. You can't give up those backwards. I guess a good kid like Courtney.
Good shot. And you got to finish this, but you're right back in the funk from Courtney's big sell here.
Yeah. Yeah. He's got a high step to that ankle. What he's going to try to do is, now he's going to try to stick him. He's going to try to put him on his head. Yeah. That's a good match.
That was a good match.
Yeah. Courtney Russell, nice match. Got that set of backwards. Really the difference. Yeah. Good job. Two competitors, two of the top wrestlers in the area. Good gentlemen. We can shake hands. You know, go see the coaches. That's what I like to see.
Yep.
That's a match, you know what I mean?
To respect.
Yeah, absolutely.
Respect.
Now, that's a big one for Athens, because that's a pivot match right there. So they're going to have to. Now you got a couple of young kids that are getting ready to go at it here. And we really need.
Wrestling for Athens, Dylan Gallagher. Wrestling for the Wolverines, Mr. Parker Larson.
Parker Larson coming out. Parker Larson's an eighth grader, I think. And man, we've got some young kids wrestling too.
Oh, let me look. Larson, eighth grade.
You know, he's 1-4 on the season right now. And he's in a big spot right now, Pat.
Who's
Wolverines down 7-0?
What your Gallagher is? You don't have any of those.
I do have Athens. I printed Athens stuff the other day.
Two matches in, down 7. You're in eighth grade. Gym's packed.
Yeah.
My nerves will be fine. Yeah.
Is this
Dylan Gallagher?
They don't have their
ages.
They don't have their ages on them.
Little ear-to-ear action going on in the middle of the mat. Somebody breaks out.
I will say the Larson kid, I mean, he's a goer. You know, he's a baby. He's a freshman, 52-pounder. Not a ton of experience on the mat. But watching him last week, I mean, he wrestled. He's built himself up to a base.
Yeah, he's not like laying there.
Although he did give him a far side crater to it. the good and the bad of it.
Sometimes you might not feel the far side crater coming in as you're.
Yeah, I mean, he was thinking about just getting to his base, right? We got full Nelson. Headgear pull again. That seems to be the move of the night.
Yeah.
Had a couple Waverly headgear pulls, now an Athens headgear pull. 36 seconds left in first period, 2-1, pretty competitive match. Nobody's really overpowering anybody here. As I say that, as Athens puts a boot in. And
I was going to say, his takedown was a little overpowering.
Yeah, you see a significant size difference here.
And strength, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, this is where an eighth grader wrestling up in varsity. I mean, he can survive, but he's not going to thrive.
Not the upper weights. The upper weights is so much tougher.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Oh.
Nah, that's the
fighting
huge right here. This is
fighting good. You got 5 seconds.
Nice job. And he gets one. That's what I said. Real hustle. So what did he do? He gave up 2 backs and got an escape. That could have been worse.
That could have been a lot worse.
Got a 4-2 score. I don't know if I put him down or if I put him on his feet. Going down. I mean, he just got rode out pretty much.
Your Bulldog Ross Walker actually going on.
Yeah, that was a double underhook on that one, so that's why he didn't score it.
You love that.
Nah, you know. Bringing it back. All right, we're finally setting up here. We got 0 time on the clock, so
the officials. Oh, that was a scramble there where the Wolverines didn't end up on the right side of it. We're in some serious trouble right here. Young Mr. Larson. This is a...
Oh, that's tight.
This is a big one right here. See, this is why you're glad you had that match. But if you were wrestling in a state championship match, you would have wanted to not have that match in that last period and went out and pinned this young man here with Connor. But, yeah, that's big six for Athens. I'll tell you what, that's a huge match.
That's huge.
Huge match. Now, you pretty much have to win. You have to win from here all the way up. You can give up one. You can give up 72, but you need to get this one, and then you need to get 89, and you need 215 and heavy, because once you got a chance to win 26, you're going to win forfeit at 103 and 110. Yeah, you need a... And you're capable of it, right? Like, this is a Waverly wrestler that won 29 varsity matches last year, was the Oneonta champion. I mean, he's capable of that. He's also capable of doing some things that make you go, what were you thinking there, right? He lost his first three matches last weekend and then won his next four. So, you know, great kid. Sometimes he's one of those guys that you have to say that's not a move. Right, so there's a shot. Not exactly a great shot. Head between the legs. But he's going to muscle his way through it. This is what a senior does. Now, if he's smart, he'll circle that.
So, yeah, he'll keep that in.
And he will. You know, he's going to try to get some back points. He gets some back points for the Wolverines now.
Is that Trowbridge?
I don't know who he's wrestling, but this is Hills. So Hills goes out there in 49 seconds, puts the Wolverines on the board with a big six. That's what his job was. He's a senior captain. Go out there, take care of your business. Get off the mat. Nice kids. Everybody good sportsmen here. So we're 13-6 now. So 13-6. 72, we got a first-year wrestler straight off the football field here.
This is Keegan Coggan.
All right, so he's wrestled a little bit, got a little experience.
Yep.
Yeah, I see Keegan here. He's a sophomore. He wrestled last year. He was 3-6 last year. 1-0 so far on the year.
Headlock right out.
And a roll through. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Look, he paid attention to something at practice. He goes out and gets headlocked and hits that roll through.
So he's usually a 60-pounder, so how heavy is this guy?
Oh, he's not heavy.
Not heavy?
No.
He didn't look that much bigger.
No, they're about the same size. Okay. I mean, he's a 10th grader, first-year wrestler. He's a swimmer up till this year. He said, they taught me the spiral ride, coach, and that's what I got, spiral ride.
Spiral ride.
That's what you're going to get.
He keeps his hips up.
Yeah, he may just wants to get his arm back.
Yeah, Keegan keeps behind underneath those arms.
Well, Keegan's got cradle now.
Yeah, he's locked it up. He's got that, use that length.
Nate's got to break that.
He's got to bump the hips.
Nate breaks it.
Reaches back.
Got to take your time. Take your time and wrestle. Take your time.
There we go. Bump him.
Yeah. Nate's got to get long here.
Keegan's moving it up. There we go.
Nate's in trouble. That's a pretty tight cradle. Well, Nate got out of it. We're going to give up two. So, but he falls out of the frying pan into the fire.
He's going to pull across. No. Right over. Power. We got the far out.
Nate's fighting to come out of there. He's in trouble, though.
He's tight.
That's a big six right there, man.
Yeah.
Big six. So we got 19-6 now. 19-6. Now we got an eighth grader coming up here, Matthias Wells, but I think he's still going to be the favorite in this match. Matthias was 5-2 last week. Who's he facing off with, Brett?
Brett.
Or Brett Pat, whatever.
So we got Tim. Jonathan Tim. The better looking brother. Remember that, yeah.
You said Brett's the better looking brother?
Jonathan Tim. Oh, let's see how this goes. Back in black, and Thias is walking up to black. Back in red and white.
Yeah, right? They can't figure out how to turn it off. There you go. There's a quick takedown.
That was nice.
Yeah, he didn't waste any time with that, did he? So this is going to be important for Wells to be able to look for six, man. So it takes time, but then when he gets the opportunity to get a fall, he's got to get it. You need those bonus points, and he did. He jumped right into a cradle. I don't know if he's – he may get the fall right there. He may have it right now. I think he's got the fall right now. I don't know what Donnie's looking at because that's the fall right there. There you go. That's a big six.
Understand?
Yeah. Shout out to all the Shishiquin boys out there that have been moved around and sent up and down the river.
Sent up and down the river. Uncle Stan, quick pin.
There you go. So that's big. That makes it 19-12. So this is a big match right here. Like I said, this was a match last year. It looked like it was headed to a major decision. And Mason headlocked Beeman. Beeman come off the mat, didn't know what hit him.
He wasn't very happy, though.
No.
Kind of some fireworks expected here.
Either was his coach.
No.
Either was his coach.
Or superintendent.
No, superintendent was not happy. So we got a 19-12 match here. Real good duel. This is what we thought we were going to get, Pat, right?
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
We both figured this is a 10-point, swing one way or another. I think
forfeits hurt.
Yeah, the forfeits are going to hurt Athens, absolutely. But at the same time, they're inexperienced wrestlers, aren't really young wrestlers, but inexperienced wrestlers were able to pin a couple of our young wrestlers.
Yeah,
and that's a big thing. And then where you're real young with Cooper Robinson, you're so
solid.
Slick. Yeah, I mean, you're going to win that. So same thing, though, can be said with Matthias Wells. I mean, that's an eighth grader going out there and getting you six at an upper weight class. So these guys are going to continue to work. You were talking about faces of Waverly Wrestling, and you wanted to bring up, you brought up Al Shipman during the break, and I was thinking Kurt Shipman and Al Shipman. Those guys, big wrestling guys in the 80s, 70s, 80s.
A lot of history. At both schools.
Oh, absolutely. Tremendous.
Athens, Waverly.
I mean, I can remember being a kid and getting on that red mat or having them on our blue and white mat down there and just being great matches. I saw Charlie Sharpstein last night. I mean, Charlie beat me my freshman year. We still reminisce about it.
Oh, I didn't realize he beat you.
Oh, Next
time I see him, I have to say something. Yeah.
Yeah. And so we were talking about that today. My dad loves to bring up the 16 career losses.
16?
Yeah.
I think I had 16 a year.
Not when I coached you.
Not when you coached me.
So we're getting a little physical out here, as we thought we would. I mean, these are both big kids, good kids, but they're not, they're not going to take anything from each other. I mean, they're going to get after each other. These are some heavy ties.
Ooh,
that was beyond heavy right there. I can't believe you didn't get a hit with that.
Yeah.
That was a little more in the club.
Yeah, I was thinking on the way in today that we must have been my sophomore because we didn't wrestle Waverly my junior year. That was a little controversy from the Athens group. But sophomore year, one of my teammates was a little overweight on the way in, and Jarvis made him get out and free move.
God, the rest of the way. So that's a 1-1, right? So that's a penalty point for an interlock, and that's a 1 there. Now, you got to watch this tie up. I don't know how long Donnie's going to let this heavy overhand left
keep coming.
Yeah. Because that kind of staggered Beeman a little bit with that last one.
Right. Yeah. Head down.
Yeah, see, I think that might have fired Beeman up a little bit, to be honest with you. That last overhand left.
Sometimes you don't want to poke the bear.
Yeah, yeah. Everything was going nice and easy. It was nothing. Everybody was getting along.
heavyweights like to kind of dance a little bit.
Start clubbing people. People
get frisky. All right. So Beeman's so tough to take down because of the size of his legs. Yeah, it's just real. I mean, that's what makes him a first-team All-State football player. And he's also, you know, I tell you, he's really a kid. When you start talking about the wrestler or the athlete of the Valley, you got to talk about Ty Beeman, and I'll advocate for him right now. I mean, he's first-team All-State offense, first-team All-State defense. He's a state returning qualifier, probably going to be a section champ this year. And then he's an All-State catcher. I mean, I don't know. I mean, there's a lot of people throwing names around, but that's quite a resume.
That's awesome.
I don't know if there's too many resumes like that. So I said that to somebody the other day. They were trying to tell me they had another athlete in mind, and I'm like, he's a great athlete, but there's two, and we got backs. Oh, if he gets a major here, that's going to be big. Watch the wrist roll right there.
Oh, the roll.
Yeah, but he's got a half.
Yeah.
So we're up 8-1 here. This could be, 8 points is a major decision. That's a bonus point. That might play big. Of course, we're also in the same situation that we were in last year.
Yeah.
Beeman up big, going into the third. I take down. Yeah, got to get your one.
Yeah.
Beeman's going to ride him for about 20, 25 seconds. I'd have to cut him probably.
Go for the major.
Yeah. Yeah, I think so. I don't think Nason's dangerous, man. I don't think you want to tumble with him. I mean, he's not. Beeman's obviously older, stronger, and a little more. Although Beeman didn't start wrestling again until last year.
I was gonna say I thought he just came back, right?
Yeah, he wrestled as like a real little peewee, first, second, third grade, and then he quit wrestling.
Ooh.
Uh-huh. Nason's a little fired up after that. But Beeman just kind of ran through him.
Right through him.
Watch a quick shot.
I thought it was a nice shot right off the whistle on that.
Yeah, there comes that hard overhand right. See, Beeman's got a good high crotch. I haven't seen it. I know he banged his knee up last week.
He digs in and goes for it. Trample that drop again.
Oh, you know what? I'm going to give Nason big credit for that. Big credit for going for that.
He
may get stuck, but I'll tell you what. And there you go, Beeman flexing. That was a big win for Beeman. But I'll tell you what, the Mason kid loaded up and he went for it. I'm going to give him credit.
He was digging in.
Yes, he was. Big win for Waverly, big win for Beeman.
Ooh, headgear.
Who did?
Beeman.
He didn't get hit, dude.
No. You sound like a. You're digging in, going for it.
Oh, that was impressive, man. I'll tell you what, I thought he had it.
285, Mr. Daniel Mills. For the Wildcats, Joshua
last year went quick, ended in the first period with a headlock by Cam. he's got locked up.
Josh backing out of it.
Not doing that.
I don't want to do that again. Pass by, try to get underneath it.
I don't think he has it.
He doesn't have it. He's just going to try using it.
See, that's where Cam gets himself in trouble. I told him today, I said, let's go slow, Cam. Slow. Cam's idea slow.
It looks like he followed your advice.
He's like,
usually you tell everybody go slow.
He's like the only kid I would say that to, right?
Yeah.
So we got a 2-1 score here. Nittinger with a nice takedown, slipping that headlock. But Hills did a nice job getting right back up. Whoa! That was. Cam just tried to go.
Scissor in the head.
Yeah, it was a scissor in the head. That's going to be one. Yeah. I don't know. Called it for potentially dangerous because he had his neck bent. So they're still on their feet. Cam just tried to go belly to belly. I don't know, man. I can't deal with this kid right now. Come on, Cam. Wrestle smart. So
So we got a 2-2 match here. A lot of action for a heavyweight match.
He's like, Mason tried a lat drop. Let me show you how it's done.
Yeah, and he's like that, too. Yeah. I mean, he's like, you tell him to do something. Oh, yeah, I can try that. How about we do this? How about we just get our head in good position, kill some time, and wrestle like heavyweights? These guys are, now we're starting to slow it down a little bit, be a little forehead to forehead. Josh Nittinger, real good kid. Gary's kid up there. Went to the regional last year. Didn't place at the regional, but good size, good feet.
Good worker.
Yeah, nice kid, nice family. Oh, he's got it. Man, he went. That's, it's not two. He came up, He came up. It was close, though. I tell you what, another second.
Do not believe what people say about the big sweaty dance, because this is not sweaty dance. They're moving.
And the thing of it is they're going to struggle to get takedowns now, because they are sweaty.
Yeah.
So we got an 18-19 dual meet right now. We got a critical matchup here at 285 with two of the best young heavyweights, and they are young heavyweights. Nittinger's a junior. Hills is a sophomore. So, I mean, both section.
Dig back in.
Hills, a New York State Section 4 champion. Nittinger, runner-up, I believe. He lost to number three kid in the state from Williamson.
Wow.
Yeah, these guys are.
Pass by, right?
Yeah, these guys are. Okay. Oh, no.
Oh. Wow.
Wow.
Oh.
What a goal.
This is
what
great.
A goal for these two big dogs.
Wow.
We're on our outdoor seats up here, guys. This is exciting.
We're still, the clock's still running.
I don't know, but you know, I didn't hear him blow whistles. Those two big boys just are like, this thing's going to end with a throw. Somebody is not walking off this mat. You got a lot of people, don't. There's a lot more don'ts being said right now than do's. And they're back into each other. So we're 2-2. So Cam's going to get choice in the third period. So, I mean, I imagine he's got to take down, right?
Yeah.
Boy, he doesn't look like he has a lot in his legs right now.
I was just going to say.
Tank, you got a little bloody nose, you said. I got a little blood over here.
Oh, look. Bloody nose. Tired out.
Hey, easy. You know, blood is a real thing. You got bloodborne pathogens.
Bloodborne pathogens.
You got to take care of that stuff.
Tired out.
Make sure you get that boy a little bit of water, too, while he's over there.
Yeah.
As this is, I think everybody can use it. I need a break. What are you talking about? I need 30 seconds. Okay, Cam, take your time there, big dog. All right, so we got hands on knees. We got some breath going on. We got big dogs. All right, Ninja goes in. He didn't have any intention to shoot for that leg. That was purely let me touch your leg and make it look like I did something here.
There's another shot.
Yeah, those aren't shot, coaches. Those are.
We're going in.
Going in looking for the bear hug. He wants to stay away from that headlock now.
Oh,
I don't know, man. Yeah. That's pretty quick. Ninja kind of led with his head on that, kind of hit Cam in the head, knocked it backwards a little bit. Both guys, I mean, nobody's stalling in this match. I'm sorry. That's a tough call at that point in that match. This is two of the most movement I've ever seen two heavyweight, high school heavyweight kids.
We'll see how this makes out.
He's got to go down. Tied 2-2. You got to go down.
Yeah.
Now, here's the thing, though. He doesn't get out right off the bat. Nittinger wants to cut him.
Yeah, he even looked over the side.
Well, Nittinger's in better shape. Oh. I mean, Cam just cut down to 285 today. This is his first time down here.
First time that weight, so.
Yeah, so. And trust me, the struggle was real. It was not an easy weight cut for Cam. He was, he couldn't make weight last week.
And what really is hard is he had that assault call. That questionable song.
Yeah, so now that plays big right
that
here.
That plays big, so if he's not going to get up.
Well, he's going to get turned right here.
He's going to get turned. Mitch's got it nice and tight. That was just tired.
Yeah, he's got to get something. He's got to get moving.
He's going over again. He's in trouble.
He's stuck.
Yeah, that's it. That's a huge match. That's a big match. Yeah. Big Cam didn't have 6 minutes in him for that one.
No.
Nice job by Nittinger. Nice job, Nittinger, with big pin
there
at the end. So that's going to put the Wildcats back up 25-18 going into these two forfeits. So it's going to be, you got to add another 12, it's going to be 30-25 going into 118. So we've got three matches. We've got Waverly up by five. We've got 18 possible points out there. We've got Josh Courtney, who hasn't wrestled yet, so they've got a hammer back, one of their better kids. And then they've got Vanderpool back. Vanderpool's back.
He's solid.
He's solid, but he weighed in at 118.4, so he's got to wrestle 26.
Which is like 1 pound, they wrestled yesterday.
Because we wrestled. All right. So, yeah. So you're going to see Mason Vanderpool and Nico Ray at 18. That's going to be a crucial match. I don't know who's got the edge on it. Courtney, I'm going to give the edge at 26. Then I'm going to give the edge to Athens at 32, even though you got two really inexperienced wrestlers. So Athens needs every point right now. Because if this is a decision, then if Josh can get a pin next match, that's going to put it away. So they need six. At least five.
I'll say tech. No pressure, just go out and pin them.
Well, and this is size-wise. These two are not really similar. Vanderpool, much more physical kid than Nico. Yeah. Nico's going to have to get on his offense. Vanderpool's going to ride boots and get real physical powerhouse here.
See if he gets up, gets his, Nick. Yeah.
Right,
man,
there you go.
Got out of that.
Keep your arms.
He's going to come in again.
Full Nelson. Yeah, and I noticed this with Vanderpool last year, too. Super strong. Real athletic, kind of gets himself in some weird situations. I mean, I don't know if he had the best gas tank last year, you know, but Nico put a lot of time in the weight room this year, but, I mean, he's still a year away from really having strength. And as you're seeing, as he's getting turned with a bar here. Yeah, so you just can't give up six. He's in trouble.
Oh, that's it.
There you go. All right, so here you go. This is going to give Athens a one-point lead. 31-30 going into your final two matches. Just could not give up the pin there. That's crucial. You know, that's the thing. You can get beat. The same thing with Cam. I mean, he could have gave up the loss, but you just couldn't afford to give up the six.
Yeah.
Can't do it. That's the thing where you got to gut it out. This is going to come down to probably the two most experienced, inexperienced wrestlers deciding this match at 32 pounds. They're working hard here.
Nice shot.
Nice high crotch.
Nice shot. See if he finishes this.
Courtney likes to chase the outside leg. He got good hip movement there.
Stuffs the head. Gives it down through. Kind of looked like he had a little surprise buff that he actually got in on him.
Yeah, I don't know why. I mean, he didn't have any hands in front of him. Yeah. I mean, it's like, kids are always surprised at how those things happen, right?
Shoot in. You can't score on me. Oh, look at that.
I got to be honest with you, Josh is a super slow starter. I mean, that's just kind of his thing.
Third period is when he comes on solid?
I don't know. He just keeps wrestling, but he's just a slow starter.
mean, he's going to work his way out here. Oh, I think he's got his arm free, doesn't he?
Yeah. Pop his head.
He's through. There's two. Now he really wants to go into that bar. So.
Roll the wrist. Come through.
I mean, he runs that. He runs his half nice. I tell you, you probably thank Sean Bradley for this, his brother, because he runs that tight. And that is tight. That's a six. Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. So it's 31-36. Waverly up by five going into your final match. Athens needs at least a tech fall to tie. A pin will win. Waverly with a victory or a decision or a major decision will be victorious. So we got Mason Ham coming out here. Now this is just this is the way it always.
Let's see who's from Athens.
Sean Peters, 130 pounds.
Yeah, that's how you're saying this.
This is it. Your two most inexperienced wrestlers are going to go at it right now. And Mason Ham comes up with a takedown right off the bat. Peters kind of fell down.
Oh,
they caught him for locking hands. Does he really have his hands locked? Is that what we're doing here? Oh, my goodness gracious. This is going to be one of those matches. It never fails. It never fails. You got state-ranked guys all over the lineup in this match. And he locked his hands again. He locked his hands again. Hey, I don't know if he's locking them. I think he's going to take Donnie and Table and say, wait a second. He's chopping. And this is way too important of a match to be missing these. Got to be touching. They're not touching them. You can't call it. Like Coach Whitman is explaining in no uncertain terms. Donnie's tired. He's done about 70 matches so far today. But we don't want this match to end on a penalty. Correct. Well, there's people in Athens that do, but yeah. I'm not one of them. Sorry. I'd rather see him wrestle the match. Oh, why not just cut him? If I'm Coach Whitman, I'm cutting him and just working on takedowns.
There you go. All right.
Take your time. But see, you're trying to coach a kid right now who doesn't really know what he's doing. So, just take your time. Look at nobody's taking their time.
Just pure excitement.
Just,
this is exciting.
Just going. No, this is not exciting.
Come on.
This is killing me. This is killing me. Come on, Mason. I'm sorry.
It's exciting for both of these guys.
Yeah, but watch it. Here's your bulldog. He's got the bulldog. He's gonna run it. He's got it. Oh, there's
the bad headlock. Bad headlock.
Now Athens comes up with two. Mason Ham getting rolled over. He's going to give up a turn here.
Oop.
Now they're on their feet. 5-3.
Amazing from
goodness. I don't even know. Like, he just kind of falls down.
Look away.
Oh. He's going. Mason Ham with a roll through. Something.
He's on top. It's
5-9. We're not tying up anything. There's no technique being done right now.
Wow. Roll each other over.
We got 10 seconds left in this first period. I don't know if I'm going to make it. I'm going to send the kids out for an Alka-Seltzer.
I want to see how many times we're going to be exposed to each other's backs. You know,
there's one. One. And he's going to give up a takedown in no time.
Oh!
So it's 10-5, ladies and gentlemen, as we sat here
second
at the Wolverine House. It's going into the second period. Mason's taken down. So... So here we go. Once again, he goes back to the half Nelson. Good success with the half Nelson on Mason up to this point. Mason's just kind of rolled
through. Letting him go through. Then he's going to roll out of this. Up. Feels the pressure. Ooh, he's got the leg, though. Cradle.
That is a cradle.
Cradle involved. No backs yet.
Swipe. He gets that arm through.
I think he's got him right there.
Yeah, that's tight. No. Oh, my goodness.
If he could throw a bulldog here, maybe. Maybe.
Just possibly. Let's see. Not a reversal yet.
That should be standing over. Well, they never gave
never touched
Cam
it. Points. Oh.
Cam's still
interlocking. And
if he can end it.
If that's 1 minute. He's fighting hard. He can't give up the pin.
Take gotta it. Give up the pin.
Give up the pin. Wolverines, wow, this has been very, so exciting.
Wow. So, the Wolverines came into that match with a 36-31 lead. They were down by 8, down by 8 points in that match. Get a ball, that's going to finish. 42-31. Wow. There you go. Wow. What a match. What a match.
This is exciting.
I mean, you know what? Good kids going at it.
Good crowd.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Sorry, sorry, sorry.
All right, they're coming back to us for a wrap up. Oh, they've got more. There's more bonus
there's more,
wrestling.
More
well, listen, we're gonna close this thing off.
It's quarter after 9. Dr. Knowles, past his bedtime.
Way past my bedtime.
This has been fun. I really enjoy doing these matches with you. Remember the one year, like COVID, nobody's here. We did one of
Yeah, we did. It was it's great. You know, obviously we love all sports, right? Like top, I mean, yeah. I love a great football game, soccer match,
top of the
swim,
first,
you know, yeah, everything. But I mean, we grew up as wrestlers,
and there's just something like that right there. Those
we
matches,
grew
those last
up
couple
as
of
wrestlers,
matches,
right? Like so, just watching these guys battle and knowing like how hard they work
all week, all year,
to
all
get their chance,
summer.
So.
And here they're out there. And,
just big takeaways, big matches.
I was just really impressed with like Courtney against Sotler.
That was a big match.
That was a big match. I don't know, like Queen Nittinger and Nason and like
Nittinger
and stuff. Yeah, those were the big matches that I was looking for and I was excited about, and they didn't disappoint. And that's what's really exciting
for me
to come in here and watch the matches that I was hoping to see.
Well, those guys, I'll tell you what, though, the Robinson kid, when you start looking at the youth movement, the Robinson kid, the Wells kid, I mean, there's some really good young kids out there as well. Waverly had a lot of eighth graders, ninth graders in the lineup, right? They'll give you a heart attack. Coach Whitman's got gray hairs after tonight, but it's coming, you know. So good programs. Valley Wrestling's always been great wrestling, love it, and just thankful these kids still got the guts to put the shoes on and go out there and get after it with each other.
Right. Be able to do it.
Absolutely.
100%. Yeah.
All right. Well, hey, for Waverly News Network, this is Dr. Owen and Dr. Knowles. We're going to be signing off. They can send you back to the extra wrestling if they will, but we are signing off as broadcasters.
Have a great night. Thanks for watching.
Okay, hey, we are back. We just looked us up. We got Jake Biesecker out here, so a little extra wrestling. First period exhibition match, 126-pounder. Jacob is. He was a starter for us in and out of the lineup last couple of days. So Biesecker coming in. His mom's Lisa McEwen. She's one of our teachers here. We're thinking about her. I think probably Grandpa's here watching the match right now. I hope he had a chance to get back to watch it. If not, if he's watching it somewhere else, shout out to you, Pips, and
Shout out to Aunt Christine.
Thinking about you guys.
Absolutely, 100%, man, 100%. So as Jakey's down 3-2 in this end of this first period, you know, he's got to get moving on bottom. He knows what he's got to do. Get some good wins this weekend. Really come a long way. Put a lot of strength on this offseason. He's starting to stretch out. He's going to be a big kid. There's still quite a few people in the stands.
That's great.
I mean, they're still hanging around. They're watching these last couple matches.
That's match. It's wrestling.
It you is, know, right? Big lift against Jake. Jake,
more matches, the better.
Well, you just get better, right?
Yeah. Like,
see, he's turning in. There's Peterson.
Peterson.
He's got it. Got it hooked up.
Oh, he's going
hang
for it.
There's Bax. Come on, Nanny. Ah, no. Nah, good call by the official.
Pop your head.
Too quick. That's too quick.
A little slower movement here than some of our heavyweight matches tonight.
Yeah, no, those heavyweights can fly. I mean, they're good.
Yeah.
Listen, when those guys get in shape, I'd wrestle that match again in like a couple of months, and you may have a different outcome, right? Like,
right.
I mean, they're two great kids going at it. That's a very close match. Cam hadn't made weight the last 2 weeks, so today was the first day that he was able to make it, and I didn't know how much he had left in the tank in the – actually, after the first 30 seconds. So I knew that was good.
He went out trying for the headlock right
yeah,
away.
Yeah, you know, my dad and I were talking about that today before the match started. He's like, what's Cam got in the tank? I said, I don't know, man. He may be at about an eighth of a tank. So
for people out there that haven't cut weight, you don't really understand until you're cutting weight for a long time trying to make that weight.
Jakey's in a little bit of trouble here. Gave up that arm bar. That's all right, Jakey. We still love you, brother. He's going to get better and better. I'm going to tell you, that kid's going to be in the top three in the section in a couple years. Again, another one of those young kids on Coach A.J. Ayerstan, Coach Whitman's team. Right, got a lot going on in his head right now. Shows up for his team, puts a W on, and gets out there. So that's what we like to see. I got to give a shout-out to Donnie Bauer today. I mean, he officiated about 100 peewee matches, about 50 girls matches, 20. I mean, he did a full tournament today, so I know I picked on him a couple of times, and I know he goes back and watches films and check out his matches and be reflective. So he did a good job. He probably won't listen this far in, so he'll just be mad at me when he sees me next week.
And it's much easier from us to critique up here about you holding back points. But
absolutely, absolutely.
You're consistent. He was consistent.
Nah, he did a nice job. I mean, there was actually, if you think about it, we didn't have neither coach until that locked hand, second locked hands with Mason Hamm. Was there, nobody went to the
table.
Nobody
went to the table, yeah.
And you're talking, I mean, they've been wrestling since 5:30. So he's 4 hours in now. Got a kick to get out of that. He gave up a tight cradle there.
Legs together. Ooh, watch the knee.
I think he's got him. Yeah. All right. Yeah, they're bendy when they're young. That's good. That's tough loss there. Good job by the Athens opponent. And I think we got one more going.
One more.
Is this Hollenbeck again? No. I know who this is. This is my favorite lead guitarist. He's in a death metal band.
Death metal band.
Dustin Gingrich. Yeah, he performs like up in Elmira and stuff. He's got all kinds of crazy stuff going on, man. He's a rock star. Keep your eye on that. Dustin Gingrich, man. He gets after it. I bought a ticket for one of his things. They were playing, I don't think it was Tags. Some other place up in, maybe it was the Haw. That's up in Ithaca?
Yeah.
I don't know, man. It's crazy. So here we go. We'll see if he's as good on his feet as he is on the guitar. Sprawling. Dustin's been wrestling for a while. I mean, I remember him in junior high. But he's not a total rookie.
Go for cradle, crossface cradle.
So he's working tough on top, got that good takedown, you know.
Trying to get a bar up, going for a half. Cradle, wow, parlay cradle.
Yeah.
Headgear again. Man.
That drives me crazy.
What's up with the headgear?
It drives me crazy.
Say, how many penalty points do they have for headgear?
Probably four or five.
That's
yeah,
so close
yeah
to
girls
five.
I think had one or two, yeah. So
interlocking headgear.
Well, it's young in the season. You got young kids early in the season.
I find if I pull their headgear, their head goes a certain way. So, you know, something to grab hold of.
Yeah, right?
Like, back
there
the cradle.
You go. He's back.
Back
well,
the cradle.
Look how long he is. I mean, he's a long, he's a very long athlete. Yeah, what an electric night for the Wolverines and the Wolverine house tonight. I mean, I call it the den. I don't know. We don't have anything else. I don't know what else we would call it, but Wolverines live in dens.
Wolverine den.
You
that
know,
sounds good. Yeah.
Makes sense. But it was good. Dustin, I'd give you a nickel if you'd throw a half Nelson in there.
Yeah.
Try to wrap this thing up. Roger's over here looking at me like, I got to go to school tomorrow, bro. Can't wrestle all night. It's all right, Roger. We keep wrestling. We may have to do a 2-hour delay tomorrow. We'll see what happens. Oh, that just went out on the air, Roger. Can't be saying stuff like that. That's fake news, ladies and gentlemen.
Fake news.
No, that did not happen. Roger will be here on time tomorrow. All right, we got third period, second period rolling up here.
I thought it was third as well.
Mm-hmm.
Half shot. Oh, he gets it on the leg. So he can pull it up.
Gingrich is long.
Yeah.
He's really long. And he uses a good, he does a nice job with his hips.
Got the two. Nope, nope. Oh. Crossface cradle. So he buries this. Goes through. Oh, man. Got some backs. A little tight, stretching them out. There you go. Got the
nice
pin.
Nice work. Yeah, I think Dustin's a kid that's going to be serviceable in the lineup, right? Like, I mean, he's one of those kids that's like, he's a second or third string in a couple of different weight classes, but he keeps paying. I mean, you watch him. He's a thinker out there. He's not just tumbling, you know? So that's going to finish us for tonight, ladies and gentlemen. We want to thank all of you who joined WNN. We had a great time with you tonight. Once again, if you have any complaints or anything about the broadcast, please don't call Dr. Knowles at the Waverly Central School District. He does not take those. This is a biased news network, just so you know, even though we do love all the athletes out there. We are a Waverly sports network, so just for clarification. All right, everybody have a great evening, and let's go.